What's up, party people? Greetings and salutations from the incognito house. This here's a lovely lady B. My name is Ichabod Bones, aka the incognito mouse. But you can call me Icky. Some of you may be wondering, Icky, why are you making another live stream? Haven't you done like 87 of them in the last 2 weeks?
87.
87. Well, I was going to make a video anyway, a few things I wanted to talk about. And Lady B was, do you want to do a live stream tonight? Just for fun? Like, sure, why not? So somebody may show up, somebody may not. It was kind of short notice, like an hour and a half ago, I created the live stream. So right now nobody's here. That's okay. Maybe nobody may, maybe not anybody show up. How did I say that the wrong way? It may be that nobody shows up. That's okay. I was going to just announce a few things anyway. Just to talk about. Just we'll wait here just a minute and see if anyone shows up. Oh, there's Tony.
Tony's here. Hi,
Tony
Tony.
from Resort Budgeting is here. Hello,
Yay.
Tony. So, people might ask, why are you making another live stream? Well, the first thing is there were a couple of people who had mentioned, who had left comments before. Oh, I can't believe I missed a live stream. At least two or three people that I can think of right off the top of my head who were saying, oh, I can't believe I missed a live stream. I missed it again. So I'm just doing another live stream just on the outside chance that maybe one of those people can catch us this time. And now we have four people here, so that's good. That's good. I hit you nose, I'm so sorry. You hit the like button.
Yay, thanks,
Wonderful.
Tony.
Wonderful. So some people wanted to see a live stream and we're just giving them another opportunity
Darth's
to do
here.
one. I'm here. Hello, my peeps.
Hi,
Darth is in the
Darth.
house.
Yay.
Darth's gotta be cold. Where are you at, Darth? Right, Iowa? Are you in Iowa, Darth? Iowa, right? Count, yeah. Des Moines, right, I think? Gotta be cold there. I
Gotta get
live.
him down to Florida.
Oh, man, yeah.
Come on, Darth, come down to Florida with us.
Yeah. Yep, Iowa.
Iowa,
Yep.
wow.
I used to live around the Mississippi River in Quad Cities, and I worked in Bettendorf, Iowa, Davenport, Iowa, and I lived over in Moline on the Iowa side, Illinois side, so I know those winters are brutal.
Brutal.
Way, way, way cold. Crazy cold. So, anyway, we wanted to do live just for fun because it's quiet tonight. The kids are out and we have a nice quiet home. No kids crawling around. I'm on the East Coast in the Carolinas.
Ooh.
Yep. Yep.
Which one, north or south?
That's about the same probably climate. Very similar to what it is here. I lived in RTP, Raleigh-Durham area for several years, North Carolina. Similar climate to what we have here. Cold, snows once or twice per winter, and a lot of ice storms. Very similar. Dave is here also.
Dave, what's up,
Good evening, you
Dave?
guys. So good to see
It
you. So, live streams are just fun. I mean, live streams are fun. The best part about YouTube is interacting with you guys. Making a video, my favorite part of making a video is the comments. Reading the comments, responding to the comments. I'm not here to try to get views and get popularity on YouTube and all that. It's interacting with you guys. I say that all the time. North in the dead center of the state.
North Carolina.
Okay,
Raise
yeah.
up.
All right. So, a couple things. I was going to go do a lakeside chat or something. See, when you record a video, you can edit out all the itchy nose stuff and
Go ahead.
all the stammering
Scratch
and
that nose.
Yammering, yeah, but when you're live, you can't, but that's okay. I always have a real bad itchy nose. I don't know what it is. So, a couple things I wanted to talk about again is just to draw attention to Lady B's channel. She just created a YouTube channel.
It's just for fun.
It's for fun. Sometimes you wear stretchy pants in your room, Chacho. It's for fun.
Chacho, need to borrow some sweats.
Lady B just uploaded another video today on her channel. So, if you want to go check out Lady B 83. She was off today. I was working. She was off, and so she just had some time around about the house to do. And look at Clover right over there. It's one of our kitties. She wants to
Clovy.
get in on the scene.
She's a sweet kitty.
She is. So she put a video out today. If you want to go check that out, go to YouTube Lady B 83 and see her video around the house.
Tony's an interesting facts. Here we
Tony was entering the facts.
go.
Adam the Woo was filming not too far from my house, near my work, over
What?
the summer.
Very cool.
Dave says I saw some of it.
Nice.
Yeah.
Thanks, Dave.
So I always want to call attention to her channel. Go check out some supplemental information. And then also, interesting, Tony, that you should bring that up. because today I was watching some of Adam's old videos. I had an injury on my hand. You can't really tell too much by looking at it, but my hand is injured. I can't make a fist all the way. My fingers, that's like the most of a fist I can make. I had a little bit of an injury that I don't know if I can talk too much about, but I injured my hand at work, and so I can't drive the bus right now. So they have me on light duty. So I have a lot of downtime where I'm just sitting around. I'm walking around talking to guests, passengers. Call them guests like I'm at Disney. Walking around talking to passengers and riding bus routes and just helping the bus drivers and just helping promote the company. So I decided I was going to go back and watch Adam DeWoo's old videos. Like, there was a time where when he first created his Daily Woo channel, it was to supplement his regular channel and he was doing daily vlogs. So I decided I was going to go all the way back for whatever reason and watch his very, very first Daily Woo video, episode number one. Tony says, Icky, I know you've only been the West Coast for a short time. Is there something you're going to miss? Well, I actually grew up in California. My family is all in California, a little bit south of us, obviously, from Oregon. But I will miss the beautiful scenery. I love the mountains. I love the topography. I love the geography. I love to go camping, and I just love the mountains. And my family's here. We've been to visit my family once since I've lived here, and it's close enough. We're going to go visit them again, and we're going to go down to Disneyland. So, of course, I love Disneyland. But, you know, family. I miss family. I miss her family and my family. As far as Oregon itself, I mean, I haven't been here long enough, you're right, to really miss that much of it. What about you, Lady B? What are you going
to
miss?
I was just talking to you about this yesterday. I'm going to miss knowing my way around. Like, I know the streets. I know if my kids get off the bus, they're going to find their way home right away. You know, at nighttime when I'm driving, I don't have to use GPS. I just know where to go, Eugene and Springfield. So I'm going to miss knowing it like the back of my hand.
Yeah,
that and is like true. Starting all over somewhere, being dropped in the middle of
that's true.
Somewhere and just not knowing what street goes where.
Not knowing your way around. That's true. That's going to be difficult. I've dealt with that many, many times. I've moved around so much, so I totally get it. Steven is here.
Steven.
Hello, Steven.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello, Steven.
Glam Drain.
Well,
that's Dan. That's Dan. Hello, Dan. So Dan is Jeff's roommate. Jeff, my buddy, my bus driver buddy, Jeff.
Nice.
That's his buddy. They were in the military together.
Very cool. Hi, Dan.
Yeah, Dan's a Special Forces veteran.
What? Wow.
So yeah, he's hardcore.
Thank you for your service.
Yes.
You and Dave.
You and
Dave.
And Dave. Yes, Dave. Gibson. Yes, you and Dave also.
Yeah.
I noticed Adam put his finger toward the camera the other day when he asked us to join the Inners in the same thing you are known to do, watching your videos incognito.
Oh,
part of the fun is getting lost. You learn from that. Yeah, driving around a new area is part of getting lost.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Thank you, Dan. Thank you, Glam Drain. Thank you so much. Dave, thank you, too. Yes. So glad to see you, Dan. I'll be back soon, buddy. Dan works at Disney in security.
Oh, okay.
So Jeff works driving bus, and Dan is in security.
Guy digging through my purse, weren't you? Quit it. There's nothing in there. Not even any money.
Not even any money. Yeah.
I'm just kidding. I appreciate the security guards.
Yeah.
Checking bags. I do appreciate it. I mean, I don't know if that's what he does, but.
Yeah. Yay, I need a shooting buddy.
There you go, babe. There you go.
I will be back. Yep, I will be back. I'd love to go out shooting. That's a lot of fun. Yeah. So, where were we? Oh, yeah. So, I injured my hand. I've got physical therapy. I've got an MRI in a couple days. I had an X-ray and nothing's wrong with it. But you can see these two fingers are close together and my middle finger kind of wonkies out that way. So, something's wrong with it. It doesn't really hurt, but I can't use it. So, anyway, I went back to watch some of Adam's original videos, like his first Daily Woo video. And I think he got a tattoo on his arm. How he did like however many, do you remember how many, what the tattoo was, how many days he went in a row doing daily video? I think it was like,
it was 500.
500? That's not that long.
The number that popped into my head.
Yeah, I think so too. That's only like a year and a half. I thought it was longer than that, but yeah, maybe that was it. Yeah. Tony says, snooping, kidding is important.
Kidding, it's important for him to do that.
Yeah. using that middle finger too much. Yeah.
I told you.
Yeah, I did do that today. There was a smart aleck in the break room. I had this.
No,
I, when I went to physical therapy, they gave me this brace that they custom made for me, and I had it on. And one of the drivers, there's a smart aleck driver. He's like, "Oh, you hurt your finger, didn't you?" I said, "Which one? That one?"
Nice.
He's like, "Yeah, whatever, something like that." Yeah. Excited for you to move back to Florida.
Yes.
Dark. We are so excited.
Very excited. Mm-hmm.
I am so excited. The problem is I'm doing live streams, I get so sidetracked, so I have to try to keep myself. It's okay, I like talking to you guys. I love reading the comments, and that's what I love the most. But
yes, that's why we're here.
Yeah, what I was saying was I went back and watched Adam's original Daily Woo number one from like 2012, when he had his van, and he was still in a band, and he was playing and driving off and down the East Coast with his van. Read between the lines. Yep. Yep. And I'm on like episode, within the course of one afternoon, I got all the way up to number 45 of his Daily Woo daily vlogs, because his vlogs are only like, when he first started, his vlogs were literally like 45 seconds long. That's it. 45 seconds long.
Wow.
50 seconds, a minute. I'm drinking a regular Mountain Dew.
There you go.
Yay.
You're kind of people right there.
Yep. I got a drink here with the, it's got some Mountain Dew in it, some Hawaiian Punch, and a little bit of vodka. Yeah. I saw a job at Disney advertised today for the same full-time bus driver.
Yeah.
They are hiring. They even have a hiring bonus right now,
a sign-on bonus.
Right
now, I wish. Yeah. I wish we had the means and it was time for us to go now, but we got to pace ourselves a little bit.
Right. We have planning and saving up money, and we have to find a place to live and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Steven, the old AT Dubs is fun to watch. Yeah. My favorite is Eliza Minnelli Mansion. I haven't got to that one yet. Maui, we'll be happy to see. Maui is Dan's dog, Maui.
Oh.
He has a service dog that he trained.
That's cool.
Really cool, like thin brown. I forgot the breed. A very, very fancy breed. It looks like a greyhound dog.
Oh.
And Maui is super cool. Yeah.
That's a cool name for a dog, too.
Yeah. Very cool dog.
I like that.
And also, Jeff's dog, Murphy.
Murphy, yeah.
Murphy's. Yeah, that's the breed of the dog that Maui is.
I'll have to look that up.
Really cool dog. And Murphy's a tiny little dog, too. Cool dog. But the whole point of bringing up Adam the Woo was he did his daily vlogs, and I was like, how do you have time to do all that every single day? And his videos were just like 45 seconds, 30 seconds. Like one of them, he was like, he was at this little skate park, and he was like, look at this skate park. I'm going to run up this half pipe and then slide down. And he ran up it and slid down, and that was it. That was the whole video, like 30 seconds. Or he was just like, hey, I'm out in this field today. It's 4th of July. Happy 4th of July. And that's all he did. And thousands and thousands of views. So it doesn't have to be like it is now, where he does this 35, 40 minute video that takes him hours to edit it. Back then, he didn't really record it the night before and edit it and then post it the next day so that he was a day behind. He posted it the day that he was on at that time.
Hmm.
So I thought, that's fun. That sounds like something that I might want to try to do just for fun, just to do a little daily, quick daily vlog. Doesn't have to be an hour long or half an hour long edited thing, just a little something just to pop in and say hi. So that's what I'm going to try to do for a week or so, a couple days, see how it goes, see if there's any interest, any interaction. Just if I'm out and about doing something and I see something interesting in the Eugene Springfield area that I want to share with you, because that's something I wanted to do anyway. But between now and the time we leave, I wanted to share interesting facts. And if I can just do it every day, like, oh, here's this restaurant that is a local place that's really good. I'm going to pop inside and show you the menu.
Yeah.
Or this is, like in Springfield, I don't know if you know this, they actually proved this. I didn't know this until I moved here. They proved that the Simpsons, the Springfield and Simpsons, is based on Springfield, Oregon. Which,
right here, yeah.
Which we used to live in until we moved here to the sister city, Eugene. And if you go around Springfield, there's all these murals all over the walls of different Springfield characters. And there's a mountain, a butte, if you will. Butte, like a little mountain with a flat top or whatever. In Springfield, it's called Skinner's Butte. Skinner! It's named after B.F. Skinner, who is Skinner in The Simpsons.
Mm-hmm.
And Matt Groening?
I think it's Groening.
Groening?
Yeah.
He grew up in Portland, right?
Yeah.
So they've done all this stuff to track down, and a lot of the names of the characters in Simpsons are named after streets in Portland, right?
I think that's what it was. I think that's the story, yeah.
Something like that. So they determined that Springfield and Simpsons is here, which Springfield we used to live in, which I drive a bus in all the time.
Yeah.
So I think we may go around and just look at different murals. All over Springfield there are Simpsons murals. It's really cool.
Yeah, just do a 45-minute video on the mural for the day or whatever. Yeah, that would be cool.
Yeah. Or different places we'd like to eat, different hole-in-the-wall places, or things that we're doing in the process of packing and moving and how things are going or whatever. Like today, Lady B did a video about going around the house and how her day goes when I was at work and she was home.
All my chores.
Yeah. Yeah, all her chores. And go check that out later. Make sure you like and subscribe to Lady B. So now that we're behind in comments a little bit, I'm going to back up a little bit.
Yeah.
Look at comments.
I was smiling at Dark.
Dar says, Lady B, I'm so happy you're here. It's nice to meet you. You seem so happy together. This makes me happy.
Yeah.
We are so happy together.
We're very happy.
It does make me happy. I have talked a little bit in the past about how I got here and, you know, things that happen. I think with the patrons, I may at some point go a little bit more in detail, maybe. I don't know. Just because I feel like a lot of the patrons are, like, actually close, are actually friends of mine. Like, the big, huge YouTubers I have, 30, 40, 50 patrons, whatever. They don't really get to know them. I feel like every one of my patrons are either an actual personal friend of mine or someone that I have met in person, like almost all of you, or I have a personal connection with. And that's really cool because that's special. That's what it's all about.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I remember you did those in your car in the Disney parking lot on the way driving into work. Yeah, exactly. Just talking just about whatever was going on in my day. Driving to work. You're right. Down I-4. Yep. Glamdrain agreed. Nice to see him happy. Lady B, it will be nice to meet you.
I'm looking forward to it, Dan.
Yeah, Dan's a good guy. Glamdrain, yep. Dave says agree with you both. Nice, thank you.
Thank you, Dave.
Tony, interesting. I went to Vegas back in 17. I've never been to Vegas.
No, we almost were going to go, but it's not going to work out.
Yeah, my work schedule. Mm-hmm. I went to Caesar's Palace. They have a restaurant called Mr. Chow's. Not sure if it was there before or after the movie.
Hmm.
Oh, he says both, yeah.
Both, yeah. Look at you.
Yeah, I agree with you both. Got it, okay. I see what you're saying. Yeah. So, I'm thinking about being inspired by Adam and just doing some daily vlogs for a little while to see how it goes. Not necessarily super long, but just something just for fun. Headed to MK tomorrow, Dan. What?
Nice. Enjoy it. Are you working or actually going to the park for fun?
Jelly.
Totes jelly.
We'll be there midsummer, sometime in July. Mid to late July is the goal.
Yeah.
We're going to visit in March. We're going to visit in March for a couple days.
Yeah.
And then we should be, if all goes according to plan, moved there by late July in place. Hopefully starting to work at Disney. So when we go in March is when I'm going to apply for buses because sometimes it takes a little bit of time to get in and get in a class and all that. Tony, one of the main characters in the Hangover movies is Mr.
Chow. Oh, okay, Hangover. I did see the first one, but it's been a while. Have you seen Hangover?
Is that the guy who says, gay? I think that's him.
Right? I don't even remember. That's how long it's been since I've seen it. He's going for fun to Magic Kingdom. Sweet. Little trading with Maui.
You doing pen trading, you talking about? Oh, training. Training.
Training.
Yeah, because Maui's a service dog. Yeah. Maui's a service dog.
Maybe he's doing pen trading.
Maybe he is doing pen trading. Maybe you did. I'm figuring.
You can bring the dog into the park. That's cool.
Yeah. I figured you meant training, but maybe you are going pen trading. But yeah. Maui's a cool dog.
You need to get a cool dog.
Yeah.
Get rid of these cats first.
After we get to Florida. Yeah.
Yeah.
Right now, focusing on getting to Florida, and then once we get there, we can look into that. Dave said, you said before it took 6 months to get hired. We'll be shorter this time. Training. Yeah, training. Well, for me, it was because I had to get a Florida license, so that's kind of the way it goes. And then once they do offer you a job, then you have to wait for the next training class, whenever the next training class is. So I'm figuring if I go in March, April, May, June, July, that's 4 months. That should be good.
Do you still have your Florida license?
No.
Did it expire?
It didn't expire, but when I got my Oregon license, you have to.
Oh, they take it from you? Oh,
yeah, they take it from you. They make you submit. I have my Florida concealed carry license. That's so good.
Of course.
But they make you surrender your license. Yeah, it's no longer valid. Yeah. Yes, Kim Chung. He's from Raleigh. Oh, he's from Raleigh. Oh, okay. Kim Chung. Yeah.
Cool.
I was just watching one of Adam's early videos, and he was at the Angus Barn in Raleigh, which I did eat at one time. I got a gift certificate for Christmas from, I was working at Chick-fil-A, and my boss at Chick-fil-A gave us a gift certificate to Angus Barn. It's just really, really fancy, expensive steakhouse, like $75 for a plate, like super expensive.
Yikes.
And they have this little machine, which seems funky, but they have this machine. Go back and watch one of Adam's original videos. There's like a wheel outside, and it's got boots connected to it. And you spin a little crank, and the boots spin around. It's supposed to be where you can kick your own butt. And he went in and poked his butt out and turned the crank, and the wheel, the boots would come around.
What will they think of next?
Kick your own, so you can kick your own butt. And that was at the Angus Barn.
That.
Yeah. Weird. It was weird. Dave Gibson, that's what I was worried about with the license thing. Yeah, and you have to get your license first because they can't offer you a job driving a bus until you have a license in the state to drive. So that's what happened the first time I moved. They said, we can't officially offer you a job, but...
I mean, that's kind of ghetto because people come from all over the world to Florida or to work at Disney World.
But right, yeah.
I mean, I guess it's probably a Department of Transportation thing.
Right, yeah. But it's actually, the funny thing is once I finally got there... How does this work? I think somehow it worked out that I could have told them that I had my license before I actually got it because they never checked with me. When I finally got there and I was living there and I established my residency and got my license, I called the recruiter. I'm like, oh, I got my license. He's like, okay, I'll put you on the list for training. And he never asked me to show it to him or prove it to him.
Wow.
So I could have called him up a month before and said, oh, yeah, I got my Florida license. And he'd be like, all right, I'll put you on the list, even though I didn't. So I don't know if later on they verify and make sure, wait a minute, you didn't have it yet.
Well, I wonder if you're still, like, maybe Oregon doesn't communicate with Florida, and if you still have an active license on file with Florida, you can just request a new license. Hmm. Say you lost your driver's license.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. Bing. I feel like they took it. Either they, a lot of times they'll punch a hole in your license, or they'll clip the corner of it or something like that.
I bet if you called Florida and requested a new one.
I might have to try that. Why is my license? Can you just...
Except if I mail it to your old address, and that wouldn't work.
No, that would not be good. Yeah, I'll have to mail it to Glen Brain, to your house. I'll just come pick it up when I get there.
Mm-hmm.
It'll be quick training for bus, big incentives to drive buses. And since I've already driven for Disney, I have experience, I don't have to go through the whole bus driver training. I just have to go through the very last part, where I just have to be re-familiarized with driving around property and learning my way around property, which I still know. I could still drive on property in my sleep. I know my way around
Disney
property.
Eyes closed.
Yeah, but you have to go through like 2 or 3 weeks of training just to make sure you know how to get around. Like, really, it's not that hard. It's really not. Darth, have you been to Mall of America yet?
It's on my bucket list.
So many great places to shop and eat. I have not. It's in Minnesota, right?
Yeah.
Like Twin Falls or like Twin Cities?
Something. I don't know.
Minneapolis?
Minnesota, yeah.
I've never been there, but it would be nice to go. Maybe
there's like a roller coaster inside.
Yeah, it's like a water park. Like, there's a whole water park,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
That would be a fun video or a fun vacation.
That would
take
be
the
really
kids
fun, yeah.
And do a series of videos.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like Great Wolf Lodge, I think, with the big water park inside.
On steroids.
Yeah, and with the whole mall connecting around it. Yeah.
Yeah. You take the kids to the water park. I'm going to go shopping.
Right? Yeah, sounds funny. Sounds fun. I mean, not funny.
Yeah.
Tony, what can you get a couple of burgers from McDonald's for $75? Kidding, not kidding. Oh, yeah, the Angus Barn. Yeah. By the way, we're going to have to go to the world's largest McDonald's. You've never been.
I have not.
But the one time I went on a live stream, you shot a little super chat and bought me dinner.
Did I?
Yes, you did. Mm. You bought me dinner. Yep. Dave says security required that too. Oh, Dave applied for security. He was going to become a security guard at Disney.
Well,
and
what
I guess,
happened with that?
I think you just decided not to, right? You decided the timing wasn't right and you had some personal things going on and you just decided it wasn't right. At least that's what I was told. Good call. Yeah. Yeah.
Yep.
So go... Oh, Tony, hold on. I think the only way to get in the new Star Wars resort by Disney bus, no parking for guests. That's right, because you're being transported to a different planet. or to a Star Cruiser out in space.
Resort. Oh, the Star Cruiser Hotel?
Yeah, the Star Wars Hotel.
Well, who stays there unless you're like a millionaire?
Yeah, ultra rich. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Security license is easy. You really can't fail the test unless you try to fail. Oh, yeah, you are security. That's right.
I need a special license. That's kind of cool.
Unless you try to fail. Well, you have to have like a security guard license, huh? Like a chauffeur has to have a special chauffeur license.
Mm.
Yeah, I get it. Even though you're not carrying a firearm or anything like that, because Disney won't let you, but I guess you have to have that. Darth, we stay at the Great Wolf Lodge water park across the road from the mall, and it makes a great vacation. They also have a hotel attached to the mall as well. Oh, is there one at the Mall of America? We just recently stayed at one.
Great Wolf Lodge.
Up in Washington State. Mm-hmm. Yeah, in Great Wolf Lodge. And it was really cool. It had the water park indoor, and not a mall, but a nice shop, you know, gift shops and restaurants and stuff. It kind of had a little bit of a Disney vibe.
It did.
Like a little bit of a Wilderness Lodge vibe, I felt like. It was really, really cool. It was a lot of fun. I wouldn't fail that. They told me I needed a Florida driver's license to start training. Hmm. Well, Dan, you already had a Florida license, so maybe that didn't come up for you. But Dave, you didn't, so you would have to have one. So that makes sense. It stinks because you can't get the job to have a license, but you need a job when you get there, which is why I had to have plenty of money saved up to be able to not work for a month or two and have enough money to live off of for a month or two when I got there. But Lady B, being a nurse, she should be able to get a job right away and won't have to wait for all that kind of stuff. So
yeah, they're in high demand in Florida right now.
Very high demand. Mm-hmm. So we get there, you'll be able to get a nursing job right away. You might even be able to secure one before we even move.
Oh, most likely, yeah.
And they'll just be like, please get come. Here. Please get here and help us. Yeah, that'll be nice. That will be nice. So yeah, was there something else I wanted to talk about? I'm not sure. Told you guys that I hurt my hand, but it's okay, but it's a little bit injured right now, so I gotta wait for that to heal before I can even consider trying to work for Disney. So hopefully that'll be okay. Hopefully I won't need surgery or anything. I think it'll be okay. And then go check out Lady B's channel, LadyB83, if you haven't yet. She just put out a new video today. Like, comment, subscribe, all that jazz. Ring the
what?
The bell notification. Ding, ding, ding. So you're alerted to all our videos. And stick around for my daily vlogs. I'm going to give that a try just for fun. See how it goes. Dave, when I win the Powerball, I'll just buy a quarter of Disney and change a policy in my favor.
There you go. Do you play the Powerball, Dave? You have to play to win.
You have to play to win.
I played video lottery today, you guys. I never win anything on those things.
Oh,
threw my money away, babe.
Threw it away. You won the one time. You won a good bit of money.
Like 60 bucks. I don't hit it big. Everyone else I know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, when you win, then you can become the new CEO of Disney, Dave. That would be amazing. Then you can run things the way you want to run. Yeah.
Yeah.
That'll be nice. That'll be fun. I feel like there's something else I wanted to talk about.
I'm sure there was.
Of course, I'll remember right after we end the video. Mm-hmm. Right. Right now,
we don't have to end it. We'll just sit here in awkward silence.
Okay. Yeah. Now we're just sitting here chatting for a while. Someone in my town won $1 million on a scratcher. I didn't know you can win that much on a scratcher.
Wow.
At a 7-Eleven.
Wow. I won $100 on a scratcher, 2 weeks ago?
Yeah, you bought a $10 scratch and won $100.
I sure did.
Yeah, you won $50 not too long before that.
And before that, on the way home from Great Wolf Lodge, I was feeling lucky, so I went to the video lottery place with a friend today, and she was up to like $72, and I put that money in, baby, and it's gone.
Gone.
Still left me, I hope so.
Gone. Gonzo. Tony says, more Mountain Dew concoction. You won't feel your hand hurting anymore.
Well, yeah, if I would have made that drink for him, he wouldn't be feeling the thing.
That's true. Yeah, it's good. Got a shot and a half of vodka in it.
Yeah.
On my lightweight.
A little bit,
yeah. But it's always just fun to come live stream and chat with you guys. Uh-oh, Dave. First change would be raises for lower level employees.
Yeah.
And payout for execs. Yeah.
Yeah.
They do need to pay their employees more. Millions of dollars for their executives, which I get it. They work hard. They have a lot of stress. But still, it's a lot of money to be making.
Especially when you don't pay the, you know, the people that are running the show, which are the cast members at the park level.
Yeah.
Especially when you're paying the minimum wage.
Yeah.
You know.
Oh, pay cuts, not payouts. That makes more sense. Yeah. Pay cuts for the execs.
Pay cuts, yeah. Did we read it wrong? No, some typo maybe.
Payout. I thought it said payouts. Yeah. Pay cuts, yeah. That's true.
Yeah.
Talk to Iger, maybe getting rid of the park reservations. That would be nice. Tony, I'm doing great if I break even or on the lottery scratchers. Yeah, most
people. You can
people.
At least win back what you paid to scratch it.
Then you're doing good, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dart says, I'm taking the family to Legoland, Florida here in the end of May.
Cool.
Can't wait. Also checking out the Peppa Pig Land.
The Peppa Pig, yeah.
Yeah, I've heard that's pretty cool for young kids who are into that kind of
thing. How old are your kids, Darth? We have 15-year-old, 12-year-old, and 6-year-old. So, 12-year-old and 6-year-old probably really like Legoland.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The older one, not so much.
Yeah.
Fat finger edges it on my phone. Typed the wrong numbers. Yeah. Legoland. I've never been to Legoland, but I've heard that it's really cool. They have a really cool water park from what I've been told.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah. Every place has water. There's so many water parks in Florida. I can't wait. 5-year-old and 1-year-old, both girls.
Oh, nice. Oh, they're gonna have you're a girl dad.
They are going to have an amazing time.
That's fun.
Peppa Pig Land.
Yeah.
And Legoland, too.
Wow. That's cool.
End of May. So we won't
quite be there not
yet,
quite yet.
But next time you come back, you have to let us know.
Mm-hmm.
Like, for real, because we have to hang out. We have to meet up with you, hang out with you and the wife and the kids.
Mm-hmm.
Got to do it.
We will.
Most definitely. Yeah. Most definitely.
Mm-hmm.
That'll be good. That'll be good. But I thought it was really cool that Adam, in his early, early videos, he was just doing, like, short videos. Just, like, 45-second videos, a minute video. Just some random, some of them were just some randomest goofy thing. He's just running through a field and just screaming. Adam was wild back in the day. He's calmed down quite a bit. But, I mean, he was in a band. He was out touring. He was just crazy back then.
He was kind of crazy.
Getting kicked out of places for going where he shouldn't go, you know, backstage areas. And all
Disney,
that kind of
to
stuff.
Be precise.
He got kicked out of, you know, he's still banned from Universal.
Is he?
Orlando. He can't go to Universal Orlando. He can go to Universal Hollywood.
How do they know? Like, you can buy a ticket and just go in.
I don't know.
Or do you have to have your name and they have him on the blackout list or whatever?
I think when you buy your ticket, you have to link it. Kind of like you have to link it to My Disney Experience.
And they're like, no, suckered.
I think Orlando has something like, or Universal has something like that too, where you have to link it to your account. And when you scan it, like, nope, man, it goes through the database and, black flag.
Got it.
Yeah. Resort budgeting. Can you use Saturday nights for the proposed trivia nights?
Well,
right now I can, because right now I can't drive a bus, so I'm on light duty, so I work 8 to 5 every day. But when my hand heals and I get back to driving a bus, sometimes I work early, sometimes I work late.
Typically on Saturdays you're working late.
Yeah, Saturdays I usually work late, so I never know. And the way it works now, should I get in my soapbox? No,
go on your soapbox. It's content. Go ahead.
When I worked at Disney. Driving a bus, I was obviously on the bottom of the pole, the bottom of the barrel in seniority. There were like 2,000 drivers, side rent, rabbit trail. There were like 2,000 drivers at Disney, and so I was at the very bottom of the seniority. So I got whatever was left. Same thing here where I work now, except there are only like 180 drivers. So I'm like 170. It's like 10 people below me. But proportionally, I'm still at the bottom of the barrel. So I get whatever shifts are left. When I was at Disney, I knew that I was working out of Epcot. That was my hub. And so I would always park at Epcot and drive out of Epcot, but really I could end up driving anywhere. That just meant that's where I parked my car, that's where I picked up my bus. I could be driving Magic Kingdom, I could be driving Hollywood Studios or whatever. But the point I'm trying to make is that I was at the bottom of the seniority, so I didn't have a set schedule. Like, we would go in once or twice a year and you would bid on what schedule you wanted to work based on your seniority. And there's a whole hundreds and hundreds of bids where you could like come in at such and such time and work till such and such time, and or you can come in midday or you could come in later. There were hundreds of bids and you would bid based on your seniority and you would get it or not. But I was at the bottom, so I was put in something that was called the pool, which just means all the leftover drivers were just thrown into a pool of drivers that they would just pull from when they needed somebody. If somebody called out sick, if somebody was on vacation, somebody had jury duty, whatever, and they needed someone to cover that shift, they would pull someone out of the pool of drivers and just assign them that. So I didn't know from day to day what exactly I was doing. But at least I knew when I was coming in. They would give you your schedule every week. I don't remember when it was. I think it would get we'd get our schedule on Thursday for the next week. It didn't give us much notice, but still, I would know on Thursday what hours I was, when I was coming in, when I was leaving for the next week. At least I knew that. I didn't know what I was doing, but here where I work, I don't know from day to day what time I'm coming in. Like now that I'm injured, like they have me on a set schedule 8 to 5 every day, but before that, and after I get done, I have to call into my work every day after 16:45, after 4:45 p.m. I call in and say, I'm just checking my schedule for tomorrow. And they could tell me, oh, you're coming in at 5 o'clock in the morning and you're doing this run. Or, oh, you're coming in at 3 o'clock in the afternoon and you're doing this run. Then the runs are all numbered. So I can go on the computer and look up the run number, FO65 or MO35 or whatever, and I can see what I'm doing. Or they might say, oh, you're a 1300 standby, which it all goes by military time. It all goes by 24 hours. So that means you come in at 1 o'clock and you're just going to sit there and wait and be on standby. So I never know from day to day. Like, I know I have Tuesdays and Wednesdays off, but I don't know from day to day till the night before what I'm doing.
It's really hard to live life that way.
It's hard to plan anything because you never know, well, can I get a doctor's appointment? I don't know because I don't know when I'm working.
Right.
Can I go get a dentist appointment? I don't know because I don't know if I'm working and they schedule me during the appointment, then I have to call out sick or I have to find someone else.
Can we do a Disney trivia night on Saturdays?
Yeah.
Right now, yes, but in the future, we don't know.
I don't know how long until my hand heals. I know I have physical therapy for 4 weeks, so at least 4 weeks I'll be on physical therapy. My next workman's comp doctor's appointment is on January 16th, so then they'll reevaluate and see where I am from there. So I'm going to have at least one more week, and in 1 week on the 16th, they could say, oh, no, you're okay, you're good to go, or they could say, well, at least finish out your physical therapy and see what happens, or let's see what the MRI shows or whatever. I don't know, but that was a long roundabout soapbox rant for a question.
Dave's asking about Adam the Woo.
So let's go back.
But someone said they can't hear us. Mic check. Can you guys hear us? Somebody said, move your mic closer to you.
Oh, okay. So we're just not talking. The phone is so far away, I'm talking quiet.
Yeah, Dave can hear us.
All right, so let's.
And they would have told us before if they couldn't hear us.
Yeah. So we'll just scoot it a little bit closer. Maybe we need to get my old microphone that I used to have. All right, so let's go back and look at some comments. Can you do Saturday nights? What did he do? I don't know.
He's talking about Adam the Woo. What did he do to get kicked out of Universal and Disney?
Well, I know Disney. So in Epcot, the old Epcot Interventions land, there used to be, it's been torn down now, but there was an Interventions, and he would go backstage in areas that were blocked off. Like, he would sneak in backstage areas that he wasn't allowed to be in, and he got caught. And that's kind of what that's how he got famous. That's how he got popular, going to abandoned places and going places he wasn't allowed to go. And so he finally learned his lesson and stopped doing that. So I think the same thing happened at Universal. He went backstage somewhere trying to get video of somewhere you weren't supposed to go. And eventually Disney, he was allowed back in Disney. But Universal, Orlando, to this day, he cannot go in. He's banned for life. So if he ever goes to Universal, it has to be Hollywood. They haven't banned him. But Orlando has. Florida has. So Kemplar. Okay, so that's a...
He's gonzo.
Okay, I didn't even see what he said.
Yeah.
Okay. He broke in there. I knew that one. Wasn't sure about Universal. Oh, I'm not exactly sure.
Probably the same thing.
He went backstage somewhere they weren't supposed to go, I'm sure. Mm-hmm. Yeah. No. Bye, Kemplar, whoever you were.
Kemplar.
Water parks, though. That's what I'm most really excited about, water parks. Being so hot there.
Yeah.
Just being able to go to all the different water parks. Universal, SeaWorld, Legoland, of course Disney. And there's this one hotel, Coco Key. There's this place called Coco Key where I used to live in New Jersey. There was a hotel and they had a water park. And there's one right in Orlando, right on I-4. I would drive past it all the time, right near Universal, like right across on the other side of I-4, right near Universal. It was really a cool looking water park. So I'm excited about that. Really want to go back to Celebration. You haven't been, have you?
I have not.
Oh my goodness, it's so beautiful.
Yeah.
It's almost like the Truman Show. If you've seen this Truman Show, like that city that he lived in, like it looks like a perfect city like that.
Yeah.
But I mean, if you watch Adam, you've seen a lot of Universe or a lot of Celebration. You know what it's like. It's just really pretty.
I keep checking for rentals there, but I think they're out of our price range.
Yeah, oh, I'm sure they are. Yeah, that would be nice. Could you imagine living right in Celebration?
That would be so awesome.
Oh, that would be. You're right there. You're like 5 minutes from. Maybe if I ever became a big YouTuber like Adam the Woo.
Oh, big YouTuber.
Big YouTuber, then we could afford it. Make sure to like and subscribe, share this video so we can move to Celebration.
Yeah, we can do videos that's in Celebration for you guys.
Yeah, that would be nice. So did I mess up the comments?
I don't think so.
No.
Okay. Got rid of that bozo.
Got rid of that bozo, yeah.
Bozo.
Good.
Bozo the clown.
Wow, he was just dropping comments like crazy, huh? Boom,
yeah.
Boom, boom, boom.
He was being stupid.
Oh, okay.
He can go away.
Yeah, bye-bye.
Go away.
Go away. Yeah. I don't know exactly. I'm sure I'll find out eventually what Adam did because I'm going through his old... His old daily vlogs, his old daily woos.
He has a video where he talks about what he did. I watched it, yeah.
At Universal?
I'm sure he has one for Universal. Yeah. I saw the Disney one.
Yeah, where he's like wandering around like a maniac. I saw that one where he's like, oh. I saw the one where he was actually being walked out of Universal. Like he had a phone in front of him and the security was behind him. And I saw him walking
out.
Yeah,
that's the one I saw when he got kicked
out. Of Universal.
He actually like escorted him out.
Yeah, I haven't seen why he got. I'm curious now to go back and see why he got.
He was going behind the scenes.
Yeah, that
he was just behind some stage or something.
That was kind of his thing, going backstage and going into things. Yeah. Like, share, and subscribe if you haven't. Thank you, Dave, of course.
Yes.
Hey, it's pretty cold here. I might have to go for a big cup of hazelnut bean juice.
Nice. Yeah.
Yes, it is cold.
I had my bean juice earlier.
Cold in Iowa, yeah. Next time you're in town where they're with you, Darth, we'll have to go to Wawa.
Oh, has Darth been to Wawa?
Have you been to Wawa, Darth?
Raise of hands. Who's been to Wawa?
Yeah, who's been to Wawa? You been to Wawa? Raise of hands. Wawa's good.
I got to go in May when I was there with you. And I was pretty impressed. I liked it. It was cool.
Wawa's good. Steven, evening bean juice time. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Every night.
Dave, yes, it does.
Wawa rocks.
Wawa,
yeah, it does.
Is awesome. It's better than like... Oh, what's that other gas station that's kind of similar? Sheetz? You ever been to Sheetz? Sheetz? It's kind of a similar thing, but Wawa is way better. LB.
Hey, you all. Hello, LB.
Hi, LB.
We're watching.
Sheetz is great, too. Yeah, Sheetz is good, but... Well, you just can't beat Wawa. Wawa's amazing.
I like Wawa.
I like Wawa too.
Yeah, Wawa's good. They had a chocolate peanut butter coffee that I had there. It was so good.
It doesn't seem like a good combination of flavors.
Oh, it was delicious. Chocolate peanut butter, and I haven't found it anywhere else.
And 7-Eleven. We have a 7-Eleven right down the road here. 7-Elevens are all over the place. 7-Elevens are good. Welcome, LB. Glad to see you here. Quick Star over here. Is what they're called, huh? Have you two been to Bucky's? Oh, no, I
no,
have not.
I haven't.
I've seen videos of them. Now they have a couple in Florida. Definitely when we go to Florida, we're going to have to go to a Bucky's. I think they're all up and down the East Coast, or at least in the Southeast. I've not been yet. Sheets and Wawa's like Cumberland Farms up here. Yes, they have Cumberland Farms in New Jersey. Yes, very similar to Cumberland Farms. None of them got anything on Bucky's. I've been to Bucky's.
So
what is
Bucky's?
It's like a Wawa. It's like a gas station, but it's just huge. They're huge. They have like, I have to watch a video on a Bucky's. They're just like 10 times the size of a Wawa. And they have like all kinds of food, like fresh food that they bake there. And I don't know. It's like a truck stop, but it's not. Because truckers aren't allowed. Like, they don't want trucks there. I don't know why. It's kind of weird. Trucks aren't allowed. Yeah, it's like a truck stop, but it's not. It's a people stop. But
a people stop.
A people stop. Because
truck drivers aren't people.
Right. Like a regular car. Regular, yeah, I don't know. Whatever.
I'm just kidding.
It reminds me of a truck stop, like a Flying J or whatever. But I saw a video where truckers were specifically not allowed. Like, they're trying to maximize their space and trucks take up too much time or whatever. Something like that. I don't know. LB, have you been to Buc-ee's in Florida? Where have you been to a Buc-ee's at? I know they have them in North Carolina and South Carolina, I think. St. Augustine, when I lived there. Nice.
Nice.
They have one near Darlington, South Carolina, off of I-95. Nice.
Cool.
I've driven many, 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 many miles on 95. Yeah. So
St. Augustine is kind of up in the northern Florida to the right, kind of toward the East Coast.
I don't know.
I think so.
Is it?
I think so.
St. Augustine is kind of northeast of Orlando. I don't know. Where is St. Augustine, LB, in relation to the state, in relation to Orlando? I thought they put one in Daytona. I don't know. Maybe. I know there are a couple. I thought Fort Myers, maybe. I'm not sure. I don't remember.
I'll have to hunt one down when we're there.
Definitely. They're opening more and more. I'm sure there will be one in Orlando soon.
Yeah.
I mean, Orlando has the world's largest McDonald's. Got the world's largest, what's that place they just built? White Castle?
Oh, yeah, like hamburgers or cheeseburgers.
Yeah, hamburger. They're like little sliders. Mm-hmm. They actually steam the burgers instead of like grilling them. They steam the meat. They steam the little hamburger patties.
Mm-hmm.
But they've got the world's largest McDonald's and White Castle right there in Orlando. I'm sure they'll bring a Buc-ee's at some point. I'm sure. LB, now I live in Ohio. Ooh, that's cold, too. That's cold. I have a friend who lives in Bucyrus. That's a cold place, too. Very cold. I'm so done with cold weather. So done.
Over it,
yeah.
Yeah.
That's why I moved to Florida in the first place. One of the reasons, to get away from the cold.
Mm-hmm.
But it'll be very nice. Very nice to go back. Still don't know where St. Augustine is, but that's okay.
Yeah.
We will visit there someday. Supposed to have a nice, really old-fashioned feel to it.
Oh, yeah.
Like
kind of like St. Cloud, right?
Yeah. Like Spanish, when the Spanish came over and colonized or whatever. Like, kind of like California has all the old missions and stuff.
Oh, yeah. That'd be fun to go visit those.
Yeah.
I haven't been to any of them.
Yeah. Like Santa Barbara and what's one of the birds all flying? So I forget now. San Luis Obispo. No.
I can't remember them all. In like fourth or fifth grade, we did some kind of like study on them, and we each had to pick a mission and like do research and all that. But I don't even remember; it's so long ago.
Yeah. St. Augustine, north of Daytona, on the east coast.
That's where I thought it was.
Okay, nice.
Yeah.
East coast, about right past Jacksonville. Okay.
Yeah.
So Jacksonville's like right on the Georgia, or right close to the Georgia border. So it's just past that. Okay. On the way toward Daytona. Yeah.
Nice.
Been to Daytona.
I love Daytona.
Daytona's nice.
It's special.
Daytona's beautiful. We drove a car right out onto the beach and walked around.
We did.
It was nice. Very, very nice.
Found a starfish.
Yeah. Starfish right on the water there. And it's nice for Lady B. She had never been to an ocean where the water was actually warm.
Only in California, but like when I was little, we went to like Huntington Beach.
But even in California, unless you're down in Southern California, last time I went to Santa Cruz, which is up in the bay, kind of in the bay area.
Mm-hmm.
The water is so cold.
I mean, we went to Monterey. Cold. We didn't touch the water, but it was freezing in Monterey that day.
Yeah, the water, even in most of California, the oceans are so cold, unless you're way down south, San Diego, Huntington Beach, Santa Barbara, down that way. But in Oregon, the beaches are just freezing cold. You don't go swimming in those beaches.
You can't even put your feet in.
They're numb when they come out.
Mm-hmm.
But in Florida, they're so warm and they're so nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, San Diego's beautiful. 50 year round. That's beautiful. LB, I lived in Jacksonville before St. Augustine. My late husband was from Jacksonville.
Mm.
Oh, that's beautiful up there.
Yeah.
The last time when I moved to Florida, the first time, on the very last leg of the trip, I stayed the night in Jacksonville. And then just drove from Jacksonville the final day to Orlando.
Mm.
But this time we're going to be staying in Georgia.
In Macon,
Georgia, visiting my buddy Dan, who is a very good friend of mine from way back in college. He's also a patron. He's the one I did the Be Kind Rewind podcast with. He still does it. I kind of kind of fell off because my schedule at Disney was so strenuous, working 6 days a week, 12 hours a day. I didn't have time to do the research. I didn't have time to watch, you know, you got to watch the movie, you got to take notes on the movie, you got to be prepared to discuss the movie and its social and cultural relevance, and I didn't have time. So I ended up finding a third person, Kyra, to co-host and kind of fill in the gaps when I wasn't there, and then it was kind of, she was there most of the time and I was there some of the time, and now I'm like, never there. Maybe someday I'd love to get back and he'd love to have me back, but I don't know.
Yeah.
I kind of felt bad. I really miss it because I like Dan a lot. But anyway, we're stopping at his house on the way down to visit he and his wife.
I think he knows
Jason. He doesn't know. Well, he might not be watching, but
yeah.
That's our plan, to stop in and at least say hi to them. Not like crash our house, but just pop in and say hi to them. You know, you all have to visit St. Augustine. It's beautiful in the oldest city. The oldest city. So I knew it was like some kind of old.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
We will. We'll definitely visit.
Michael, who's going to win the college championship, Georgia or TCU? Welcome, Michael.
Hi, Michael.
I kind of stopped following college football when the Oregon Ducks kind of took a nosedive at the end of the season.
Yeah.
We're Duck fans, and they were doing so good. They were like ranked, I don't know, 8th or 6th, something like that. And they were poised to become number 4 and play, and they didn't. They kind of tanked. So I don't know. Probably Georgia, I think.
Georgia. Dave says Georgia, must be Georgia.
I think so. LB, I was a licensed walking tour guide there.
Wow.
Oh, in St. Augustine.
That
wow.
would be fun.
That would be so much fun.
Yeah.
I was just watching one of Adam's videos the other day when he was in Key West, and he was going on a guided tour, and the tour guide was so cool and so energetic and fun. That was fun. I want to go to Key West too.
Yeah.
That would be fun. We will go at some point.
We will.
Furham, is it?
Furman?
Furman Family Adventures. Icky, good to hear you're moving back down to the House of Mouse.
Yes.
Sounds familiar. I've seen you guys before. Yeah, thank you for stopping in. Yes, I'm so excited to be going back to Disney.
Excited.
Something about working at Disney. It's just so magical. It's just so much fun. And I mentioned before, driving a bus is driving a bus. I mean, I'm not like out there. I'm not in a character costume. I'm not operating a ride. I have what I consider just like a regular blue-collar job. It's the same job that I do here in Oregon, but just something about doing it there on property, picking people up on vacation, seeing them in all their Disney gear. There's Disney music playing on the bus. You pull in, you see the fireworks. Pull into Hollywood Studios, bus loads up, you see the Skyliner coming down. You hear the music. It's just so magical.
Mm-hmm.
Then when you go on your break at Hollywood Studios, you go into the park and you go backstage, and you're backstage and the Tower of Terror is right there. And you can say, oh, it's just so amazing.
It sounds wonderful.
It's so amazing. Like taking my break at the Magic Kingdom, there's a little break room they call the Hill. Dan, if you're still here, you know the Hill is a little break room. As soon as, before you actually even go into the park, it's a nasty little break area. But
it's nasty.
It's one of the worst break areas in all of Disney.
It's just like dirty?
It's just outside and it's stinky. Oh. And it's a lot of the security guys, no offense, Dan, a lot of the security guards take their break there and it gets crowded and there are people smoking. But it's, you can, and like Space Mountain is right there. It's like right there.
That's cool.
It's so awesome.
Wow.
Dave says Georgia. LB says, yeah, I live in Cincinnati. Well, a little bit outside of there. Thankfully, the football players are recovering from the game.
Yeah.
Monday night. Oh, yeah.
I heard about that.
He finally was able to go on social media recently. I think I heard he sent out a tweet or something for the first time.
Wow.
He did a video chat with the team and he said, I love you boys, or I love you guys, something like that.
Mm.
He was able to like FaceTime or something like that. And only once in a while is a meth head on your bus. At Disney, yeah, at Disney I never had anything. There was a live stream I think I did one time where I went on this complaint about all the terrible behavior at all the Disney, at a Disney, like, and she was laughing at me when I said, oh, there was a kid that they let him pee. Went in the corner and peed outside, and I was like, oh, I can't believe they did that.
But can you see it now that we have a 6-year-old?
I still don't approve of it, but yeah, I could see how if you have to go, you have to go. But here, now, it is, you know, driving a bus here, yeah, meth heads and homeless people and people spitting on you and people bringing alcohol on the bus on a regular, like at Disney, every now and then, they'd bring one, because if they were at Epcot drinking around the world, but you could see their glass, you could tell it was an alcohol, and you know, you can't. Sorry, buddy, you have to drink that now. But on the bus, it's on the bus I will drive at now. It's bad. It's bad. So I will be so glad to be going back to Disney, driving people around in the Magic. It's going to be so much fun. It was a paranormal historical tour. It's one of the most haunted cities too. You had some experiences. Ooh, you tell. Wow.
Yeah. Interesting.
Wow. I'm subscribed to a YouTuber called the Paranormal Polynesian.
Yeah.
Adam. And also ATJH Paranormal Travels, who does paranormal stuff. I'd love to check their channels and see if they've been to St. Augustine. That sounds interesting. Paranormal stuff is interesting to me. It's kind of like cool, especially when they have little machines and they can hear voices.
Fascinating.
It's very, very interesting. Furman family, we're in Cincinnati as well, in Loveland area. Wife is a CM at the last remaining Disney outlet store here in Ohio.
Oh, very cool.
That is cool.
I'm sad to see all the outlets go.
Yeah.
We had one here in Eugene. It's probably been about 15 years since it's closed.
Yeah.
And then there was one, there's still one in Woodburn, and then in Portland there was one, but that one recently closed too.
Woodburn is the last remaining. The one that I went to recently is the last remaining. This is Matilda, by the way. This is Matilda. We call her Tilly.
There she is.
A.K.A. Tillymook.
Really sweet.
She is really sweet.
A little
sweet.
Bit needy.
Yeah. Very clingy, and she cries if you don't give her attention.
Yeah, she does.
That's exciting that your wife is a CM. Do you guys get, like, passes and gift and Blue ID and guest pass or main gate passes? What am I trying to say? Like, Walt Disney World cast members get? Do they get all those benefits? That would be cool. LB, yeah, I'm in Fairfield. Okay, Darth, hey, I'll have to catch up later. I have to go to work soon. I work third shift. Thanks again for making great content. Your fans, have a good night. Thanks, Darth.
Bye, Darth.
Thanks so much for popping in. We will see you soon.
Join us again. Yep.
Shall you?
LB,
I was born and grew up in Cincinnati.
Cincinnati.
WKRP in Cincinnati. Tony.
Tony's so funny.
Only girl I'm scared of is in Haunted Mansion. Totally kidding.
Totally kidding. Okay.
LB, OMGZ. I'll have to go to the store. I didn't know there was one in Ohio area. I miss Disney so much. Disney is so magical. Everyone connects with Disney.
Yeah.
I think Disney now is becoming the point where you either love it or you hate it. Like, there aren't that many people that are just like, meh, Disney, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
People are like, oh my goodness, I love Disney so much. Or they're like, oh, Disney is so woke, whatever. You got to love Disney, though. It's just, I mean, I don't always agree with everything they do politically and all that kind of stuff, but it's Disney.
I grew up with it.
Yes.
So it's ingrained in my soul.
Yes. We used to have, like, Mary Poppins and Lady and the Tramp and the old VHS, Disney VHS. Used to watch Lady and the Tramp so much,
yeah.
and Mary Poppins all the time. Stuff like that. I loved it. Loved it. Loved it. Yeah. Andy. Hello, Andy Hammer.
Hi, Andy.
We are late to the live, but have you already been hired to Disney bus driver? I have not applied yet because it's kind of a little bit far out. Like, it's only January now. We're not moving there until July. And this will be my second time working for Disney. I already worked there once before. I was a Disney bus driver for about 2 years or so. So I already know from experience that if I call and apply now, I can go through the process. I can speak to a recruiter. And they would say, you are a good fit. When can you start? And I said, well, I still don't live in Florida. I've done this because when I did it before, I still lived in New Jersey when I applied. I went through the whole application process by phone in New Jersey. And they said, well, I can't officially offer you a job as a bus driver yet because you need to have a Florida license for me to offer you a job. So when you get here and when you get your Florida license, give me a call back and then I'll offer you the job then. So I already know how it's going to go. I already know they can't offer me a job until I get there, officially anyway. And your application is only good for 6 months. So if you apply, they extend you the job, then it's only good for 6 months, and then you have to wait 6 months before you can apply again. So I don't want to get in that zone where I can't apply again for 6 months. So we're going there in March, so I'm probably going to go in March. I'll probably just go there to the casting building in person myself, or I'll just go online and apply then so that I'm close enough. So long answer, no, I have not applied yet because I know how the process goes and I know it's not time yet. Furman Family Adventures. Yes, we have main gates. Nice. So you're very similar to the actual Walt Disney World cast members. That's
nice.
Beautiful. Dave, if there's one park you could get in.
Park job.
Oh, one park job you could get in that isn't a bus driver, what would it be? I've talked about this before. I would be Goofy. Like, I would actually be, oh, I would be friends with Goofy. I'd like to be the Goofy character, because a Goofy character, you need to be someone tall. You have to be tall to be Goofy.
I think you'd be really good at being Goofy.
I'd be really good at being Goofy, because yeah. Goofy is my spirit animal.
And you do the voice so good.
I already have the mannerisms of Goofy. I don't want to be Goofy. I don't want to get in the costume and be friends with Goofy and do that. Or I want to be a monorail captain. That would be fun, too. I would love to drive the monorail. So that's two. Sorry. Tony, I have a few family and friends that have lived in Orlando over the years. They constantly refer to it as the House of the Rat.
Aww.
I think it has to do more with the tourists. Yeah, I've heard that before, too.
House
yeah.
of the Rat, that's sad.
A lot of locals don't like all the tourists. They're like, it's kind of like when
they don't have to pay state income tax.
Yeah,
like,
that's
they
true.
They just chill out, you know.
That's true. But the tourists clog up the roads and they make things more difficult. I get it, because when you have tourists driving and they don't know where they're going, they're swerving around and they're going slow, it can get frustrating. But I always had to tell myself, these people are the reason I'm here. Like, I couldn't be here without them. They're paying my salary. They're making it possible for me to have this job.
Mm-hmm.
But I can see how locals who maybe don't work in the you know, theme park industry, they just have regular jobs, whatever, they can be upset about it. I get it. That makes sense. They've applied to Universal as a backup. Mm-hmm. I mean, they do have a few buses at Universal, not a lot. Like, they have a few buses that drive people over to the water park from their hotels, because the water parks are not close enough. And they have some that drive around. They call them team members, not cast members. They have a few buses that drive around team members, but it's only part-time. I just may. Go make things out of clay and lay by the bay. I just may. What do you say? Andy, thanks for the info. Yeah, that's why I'm here. Yeah. LB, yeah, he was he was trespassing in places where he shouldn't have went. He was being bad. But it was his gimmick. Talking about Adam the Woo.
Yeah.
Mr. Morrow just moved there.
Oh.
Where did Mr. Morrow just move? He moved, I think I saw on his video, he said he's moving behind Magic Kingdom, which would mean north of Magic Kingdom.
What would that be?
So there's like some, I don't know, there's some,
Dr.
Phillips is a little bit further north. There's like a few communities just north of Magic Kingdom. Like, there's Magic Kingdom, and then just beyond that is like some Disney University, and then there's some houses just north of that. I don't know what it's called, but there's some communities. I thought that's where Mr. Morrow said he moved to, but give me more information. Mr. Morrow just moved where? That was me last month. CM's at the stores have the same benefits at CM's at the park. Our plans are to move down there once our youngest graduates high school. My wife is going on her 12th year with the company. Nice.
Wow.
I was a bus driver, and during the lockdowns, when everything closed down, you know, we were all furloughed for a couple months. But then they called me and they said, we don't have any bus driver positions available yet, because I was still in training. I hadn't graduated and become an official bus driver yet. And even if I had, I was so low in seniority. But they called me, Global HR, and said, we don't have any roles for bus drivers, but do you want to come back and work at merchandise? And I said, yeah. Because at the time, unemployment?
Unemployment.
I wasn't
yeah.
getting unemployment because of some snag-ups with New Jersey. But anyway, I went and worked at Disney Springs, and I worked in merchandise. I worked at the Disney Days of Christmas and the Goofy's Candy Store. And the art store, it was so much fun. I loved it so much. If they paid the same as a bus driver, I would go work there for sure. But bus driving pays more. But that was a lot of fun. So hopefully you can come down here once your youngest graduates high school. That would be nice. Tony, sorry, I was just saying what they say. Please don't block me.
House of the Rat.
No.
No, Tony, you're cool. You're good.
He is back there with a couple Disney YouTubers. So that's what you're talking about, Mr. Morrow. He's living back there with a couple YouTubers. Yeah. I eat pieces of expletive like you. Tony, you got it. Yes, Tony, you got the quote. I eat pieces of...
I figured you were quoting a movie.
Yeah. It was
Play Down by the Bay.
Happy Gilmore, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Happy Gilmore. And then Tony came back with Shooter McGavin.
Nice, Tony.
I eat pieces of crap like you for breakfast. You eat pieces of crap for breakfast? No. LB, it's 29 degrees here. Oh, in Ohio. Yikes.
Colder than here.
Yeah, colder than here. Dave, yes, that's where you met me the first time, when I was working at the Disney Days of Christmas.
Aww.
Right. Yep. Dave and Sid and Michelle.
Aww,
met them there. His daughter Sid and his wife Michelle.
Aww.
Lovely, lovely people. And the second time I met you, at Magic Kingdom. You actually came out to my bus and found me as I was pulling in from wherever. And you met me at my bus, and we hung out for a few minutes until I had to go. And then it was back off into the park you went. I met DVC Kev at Magic Kingdom, too. I met Tony Resort Budgeting at Magic Kingdom, too. That's the place to be.
I guess so.
I met you at Universal. We talked about that in the last live stream.
Yeah, sure did. Diagon Alley.
Yep. LB Wawa is amazing. Oh, back to Wawa. I love that place.
I can't wait for Wawa.
I love that place. It's so good. Yeah. Andy, we all love Disney and Universal, but what are your thoughts on Universal building another park and Disney keeps building and the parks being overcrowded? Wow, that's a lot. All right, so let's see. Yes, we all love Disney and Universal. My thoughts on Universal building another park, I can't wait. Epic Journey, isn't it called? Epic Journey
Epic
or
Universe.
Epic Universe?
Yeah.
I can't wait. This Super Mario Land, yo. Mm-hmm. I grew up in the 80s, and I had Nintendo, got in the regular old school NES when it came out in like 85. Super Mario Brothers was like groundbreaking, from the old Atari 2600 to playing Nintendo.
You say Atari?
Yeah, I had an Atari 2600. That's how old I am.
I was like three.
I had Atari 2600, yeah. Playing Pitfall and Berserk and Space Commando.
Ooh, she's
getting feisty. To get a Nintendo Mario, I can't wait. I think it's a good idea. I think it's a really good idea.
I just hope they build it big enough. I hate it when they have this idea, like, we're going to build this land or whatever, and they cram it into the smallest confined space, and there's like, you know, three places to eat and like two rides. And they, like, you walk through in like 10 steps, and it's like, that was it.
Yeah, that's it.
So I just hope they like really make it a big park.
Yeah. Well, they're going to have like a Donkey Kong ride, I think, and then they're having like a Mario Kart, and it's supposed to, and like a Monsters section of the park. It's supposed to be really cool.
All right.
I'm excited about that. And then I think that once they do, Disney will feel the pressure and they'll build something else. The parks are definitely overcrowded, but I think that's by design right now. I don't want to get myself in trouble, but I think that Disney is intentionally raising the price to price people out because the parks are so overcrowded that they're thinking, well, if we raise the prices, we can make the same amount of money that we're making now and have fewer people in the parks because poor people won't be able to afford to come into the parks. Mm. So there will be fewer people in the parks, but we'll be making the same amount of money. So they're doing that. It's capitalism, which I'm not knocking capitalism. It's better than communism, but that's just the way it is. I mean, that's business. That's just the way it is. So I hope that Disney makes another park. I think it would be good. They have plenty of room too, right? Make a fifth gate. There's been talk for years about making a fifth gate. So I think that once Universal made the Harry Potter land, that's when Disney stepped up and made Avatar. Like, oh crap, we have to do something to compete with him. So I think once Universal makes this other park, and Disney's going to feel, they're going to feel it in their pocketbook, because a lot of people are, at that point, Universal will have three parks and a water park. It will be big enough to be in a complete vacation destination on its own. Like, up until this time, a lot of people will go to Disney and then they'll go to Universal for a day. Like, that's the way it usually is. But Universal will be big enough to be their own destination. Like, you'll just go to Universal for your whole vacation. They're going to be taking money out of Disney's pocketbook, and they're not going to be happy about that.
I mean, as they should, they do it really well.
Yeah.
I mean, a lot of people just prefer Universal over Disney at this point.
Yeah. And competition is good. Competition is what makes innovation. Like, if Disney needs to up their game to compete better, then that's how things get better. So I like the whole idea. I like it. All right, LB says they are huge. What, the Wawas, or what are we talking about?
I know, a while ago we got off on a tangent, didn't we?
Yeah, then at Hollywood Studios. Oh, St. Augustine? I don't know. It's hard to keep up. It's hard to get on a tangent.
Sorry, guys.
You lose track of what people are talking about. All right, that's it. Off to watch Happy Gilmore. Thanks a lot.
Okay, Tony.
Furman, LB, Bucky's is better than Wawa. Well, they better be really good then, because Wawa is the stuff. I love Wawa. So if you're saying that, then I'm excited. I've seen a few videos of Bucky's, but Adam the Woo and other people, but I've never been to one. So I'm looking forward to a Bucky's. I hope they build one in Orlando. I hope they do. They should. Forrest Whitaker's left eye.
What? Forrest. Why did you block somebody?
Forrest Whitaker's a dude that has like a lazy eye.
Wow.
Your wife has been cheating on you for 6 months. I'm sorry, buddy. Well, that stinks. I'm sorry for it. That's terrible. That'll be on the East Coast before I get to Daytona. Oh, you're talking about a Buc-ee's. Okay. Dave Gibson. Oh, the Atari 2600. Yes. Asteroids. And Andy says, I agree with you, Lady B, on Epic Universe. About being too small.
Yeah. Just like Pandora. I feel like, yeah, it was really, the way they made it was really cool. There's a couple of, you know, really cool rides.
Yeah.
And, you know, some good food. But, like, literally, it's just this little corner at Animal Kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
So it was kind of a disappointment in that sense.
And the Navi River Journey is not that good of a ride.
Yeah,
like, maybe. It has no point. It's like just a watered-down Pirates of the Caribbean with a few little... I mean, it's pretty mm-hmm. with the black lights and the neon colors, but there's no point. There's no story.
Yeah.
It serves no purpose other than just to take up capacity, I guess. All right, Furman, I agree with you, but Disney built too many resorts and not enough park space to handle the new resorts.
Right.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Furman, they are building more resorts and no more expansion on the parks. Well, that stinks.
Mm-hmm.
I believe it was Celebration. What was Celebration?
I don't remember.
Not sure. Buc-ee's is awesome. Way better. Good, I hope so. That's good. Furman, wait, did we... There's a Buc-ee's in Daytona and St. Augustine.
Well, then we're going to have to go over there.
Nice. Yeah, for sure. Furman. There's a Buc-ee's in Daytona and St. Augustine. Okay. I thought Forrest Whitaker had put another comment. I guess not. Okay. Maybe not. Forrest, welcome. He's sure to hit the like button now. Welcome. Be sure to like. Yes. Be sure to hit the like button, Forrest Whitaker's left eye. A troll. Hope you're not a troll. Hopefully you're just being silly.
Hopefully.
There was this one.
You will get blocked if you're a troll.
Remember those two channels that we thought one of them was a troll?
Yeah.
There was a person. I'm assuming
Anakin Skywalker.
No, it was Anakin Buttwalker. Something like that, right? It wasn't Anakin Skywalker. It was like something like that.
And Walker's Anakin or something like that.
Yeah.
They had like two flip personalities.
And it was like, one was the bad brother and one was the good. Oh, I'm sorry, my brother was just here. And the guy would come in as Anakin Buttwalker. And then he would be like all mean. And they'd come back as Buttwalker Anakin. And be like, oh, my brother was here. I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah. You remember that, Dave? And I'm so sorry if my brother said anything mean or rude. He's kind of a jerk. Then he would log off and the other one would come back.
I swear that person was like 12 years old. And I told him too, are you like 12? Like,
probably.
Stop being annoying.
Yeah. It wasn't as simple as Anakin Skywalker. Some kind of off color, not super dirty, but
I think it was Buttwalker.
No, it was something like that. It was something like that. Yeah. So I was wondering if that was Forrest. If we're gonna come back and it's gonna be all of a sudden Forrest Whitaker's right eye. Oh, I'm sorry, my brother was in here. Was he causing trouble?
It's like, oh no, not that again.
That would be so funny.
Hey, look, Adam's here.
ATJH. No, this is
Adam?
No. No, this is ATJ. This is Andy.
Oh, Andy.
Andy was one of it's Andy, right? ATJH is the four letters of the four people in his family.
Oh, that's
Sledgehammer
cool.
That
okay.
Like button. And Andy, I think it's Andy.
Right? Adam's the other paranormal.
Paranormal Polynesian.
Okay.
That's Adam. This is
Andy. Sorry, Andy. I got it backwards.
Please correct me or make sure that that's right, because Andy was one of my first contest winners. One of my very first giveaways.
Oh.
He won.
Oh, yeah. We're going to do that giveaway.
Yeah.
On like
Tuesday. Watch. By the way, go back and watch our giveaway video if you haven't seen it yet. We're giving away this really cool 50th anniversary Haunted Mansion Doom Buggy, which, by the way, I was just watching a video by Offhand Disney. You know who Dallin is? Offhand Disneyland? He's a big Disney YouTuber, and he just did a video, like, today or yesterday, and he had that Doom Buggy in his video, like the same exact one that we're giving away. He showed it in his video.
Is it worth something now? Probably, since it was 50th anniversary, they're all sold out.
Probably.
One of you guys are going to win it,
yeah. So go back and watch. I don't know Dallin or anything, but if you watch Offhand Disneyland, go back and watch his video from today or yesterday. And he's talking about the invention of the Omni Mover, about how it started and all the different rides it have. And he had one in his hand and he showed it.
That's cool.
The exact same. I was like, yes, that's the one we're giving away. So go back and watch our giveaway video and you can enter to win that 50th anniversary of the Haunted Mansion Doom Buggy. It is so cool. It is very cool. And there's Tilly.
There she be.
Tilly Mook.
Andy has to go.
Awesome, Andy. thanks for stopping in. Can't say we'll rewatch later on the flip side. Well, thank you for stopping in.
Yeah.
Thanks for watching. Come back and watch us later.
No, the other eye.
Yes, Offhand Disney is great. I like his channel. And I love that. I was just watching his video and all of a sudden he showed that exact Doom Buggy that we're giving away. I'm like, that is such perfect timing. It is so cool.
That is cool.
It's in, he has it out of the box. Like he has it in his hand.
Oh.
But he showed it. And he pushed a button and played the music and everything. I was like, yes, that is so cool.
Mm-hmm.
His video about the Omni Mover and how it was invented and all the rides that have it. It's really cool. Really cool. Andy, will you let us
viewers know how
house hunting goes? Yeah.
Of course.
And interesting. Yes.
He's gonna
so I'm going to start doing it.
We got you, Andy. We understand.
I talked earlier. I'm going to start doing daily vlogs just like Adam did back in the early days. Not super long necessarily, but we're going to take you on this whole journey with us. We're going to show you how we purge the house, how we downsize, what's outside the window. It's just a street. It's just a street view.
Darkness, people.
Yeah, that's a super tall rose bush right there. So she's just...
She's just checking it out.
She's just looking at the street outside.
I'll be right back.
Okay. We used to have Christmas lights out there. We just took them down like a couple days ago. So we had a Christmas tree in the yard and we had all kinds of Christmas lights and all kind of, we had a light pole and a penguin light all lit up. So Michael, nothing out there now, just except she wants to see what's going on. Death Star 5000. What's up, Brian? What's up? What's up? Good to see you. Good to see you. Dave, Offhand Disney is great. I love his videos. Yeah, I know I already talked about that, but I'm just going back and looking. ATJH, Andy, if you're still here, have a good night. Watch us later. Make sure you like, subscribe, comment, share, all that kind of stuff. Death Star 5000. Good to see you. Glad you're here. We've been going strong for a little over an hour, an hour and 16 minutes, and we have 14 people here, which for me is a really good live stream. I know I'm not Resort TV one with hundreds and hundreds of viewers, but for me anything above like 12 is good. Like even on a walking around Disney, so 20 is like, I think 21 or 22 is like the most I've ever had, so that's really good, really good. Adam's Andy says we love Adam. He and his mom are in Key West at Hemingway's house. I saw that. Oh, I didn't know he's yes, I saw his video where he was at the Hemingway, yeah, with all the six-toed cats, right? I did see that video. Yeah. That's very cool. Gotta tell them to hit the bell also. Yes, hit the like button, hit the bell notifications so you get all of our notifications. Nope, there goes Tilly. Yeah. Adam's a lot of fun. I kind of draw inspiration from him sometimes. Sometimes I accidentally, without realizing it, kind of fall into doing things the way he does them because he's like one of my favorite YouTubers, which is kind of why I'm getting inspiration from him now, and I'm going to start doing some daily videos, daily vlogs, just for fun to see how it goes. And if it works out good, then we'll continue doing them. And if it doesn't, then we'll just go and do videos every now and then. But you do want to go check out Lady B's channel. Let's see if I can pull up her channel real quick, send you a link to her channel. Lady B just recently started doing videos on her own channel. It's Lady B 83. And she is doing videos. Well, let me see if I can copy that. YouTube.com/LadyB83. So we're going to share that out. Go watch her channel. Subscribe. She just did a video today. She was off today and I was working. And she was just around the house and around town doing stuff. But yeah, go check out her channel and the video that she just did today. See what you think. Looks like I fell way back in the comments. What did I miss? Anything? No. Yeah, so give her a little bit of YouTube love. Let her know what you think. And there goes Chloe.
Mm-hmm.
Chloe heard you pouring a drink.
She sure did. That was for her. Sorry.
And after three rounds of Jose Cuervo. Actually, it's just Mountain Dew, but
it's
a cool little Jose Cuervo cup. Resort budgeting. They also filmed License to Kill with Timothy Dalton and Key West at the Hemingway House. Bond, James Bond. I did hear something about that. I remember that. They were saying where the stuntman, he's like, and this is where the stuntman jumped over the banister right here. I remember hearing that in the video. Furman, when you go back to Disney, will you be bringing back the sunglasses in your videos? Well, I mean, I do wear them sometimes,
when
but...
when it's sunny.
Yeah, when it's sunny. The reason why I did that, and it's a long, again, a long side story, the reason why I did that in the beginning was, before I moved to Florida, when I was in New Jersey, still planning on moving, I wanted to do a YouTube channel that I could talk about Disney and share with what I felt. And I was afraid that if I said anything about Disney, or if I was a YouTuber and I also worked at Disney, then they wouldn't allow that and they would make me quit. So I came up with an incognito disguise so that no one would know who I was. If you go back and watch my old videos, I was like, you're never going to know who I am because you can't see my eyes, which was kind of silly anyway, because facial recognition can recognize you with a hat and sunglasses. Even with a mask on, it can still recognize you. And Disney has... Newsflash, Disney has facial recognition at the front gate of the parks. They do. They have cameras and they have facial recognition. So they know who you are. They know who's coming into their park. But it became difficult because I was trying to keep up the disguise and I would wear my sunglasses at night when it was dark and I couldn't see. And I wear glasses most of the time. I wear contacts sometimes. I have to put my contacts in, put my sunglasses on. So, I mean, if it's sunny and bright out, which it usually is in Florida, then yeah, I'm going to have my sunglasses on. But if I'm inside like this, in my earlier videos, when I was trying to keep my disguise, I would wear, I'd wear my sunglasses in the house. I'd wear my sunglasses at night. I'd be doing my late night poolside chats or my late night walk around, and I have sunglasses on. I remember in one of my videos at night, I was walking around Nikon Park, and I would, when I had the camera facing me, I'd put my sunglasses on. But then when I turned them around to face away, I'd take them off. And there was one time where I forgot to take them. To put them back on, I had the camera facing away, and it flipped it to me, and they weren't on. I'm like, oh, and I put them on real quick, and everyone oops. There, Dave was there, and maybe some of you guys
there.
Might have been there. You were there.
I blinked and missed it, even though I already knew what your eyes looked like.
Yeah.
It's a different story.
And so, I mean, I'm not going to try to disguise myself anymore, because, you know, I don't care anymore. I know that, at that time, I was afraid that Disney wouldn't allow me to vlog and be a cast member, but now I know of several Disney vloggers who are cast members, even big Disney vloggers who are cast members who let people know their name, let people know where they work, and it's not a problem. So I don't have to keep the incognito anymore, but it's kind of my trademark, it's kind of my signature, so I'm gonna still be icky, I'm still gonna do the incognito thing. You hear Tilly crying over there? She's really super needy.
Oh, she's
if you don't pay attention to her, she cries. Yeah. Oh, Dave says, oh, getting another drink.
This one's non-alcoholic this time.
Yes, I'm trying out some Bud Light Seltzers. Bud Light Seltzers, ooh, sounds good.
I've had those.
Yeah.
They're okay. I prefer the White Claws.
White Claw, yeah.
Yeah, the Ruby Red Grapefruit White Claw. It's really good.
Nice. Resort budgeting, Jose Cuervo, you're a friend of mine. I like to drink you with a little salt and lime.
There you go.
Yes. Don't ever have a Bud Light next.
After like vodka.
Ooh, I've heard that.
Didn't
drink.
You learn that? Like,
yeah.
Pretty early.
Yeah. You
the
drink
summer.
Hard liquor, then you drink out beer after that. It's like not.
It was not good.
Did not end well. No.
Poor Icky.
No. Dave Gibson, I did not get bag searched getting on monorail. Oh, wow. Interesting. Andy, we're looking forward to you and Lady B and the journey back to being a cast member at To Disney. We're excited for you both and can't wait to the growth of your channel as being incognito must. Thank you,
awesome.
Andy.
Awesome. Thank
I'm
you.
I'm excited.
We are very excited.
I'm so excited. I miss being at Disney. I miss the interaction. That's why we're doing so many live streams. That was my favorite thing to do back in my back patio.
Yeah.
In Orlando, in my condo, or walking around City Walk, or walking around Icon Park, or down, or Disney, I almost said down Disney. Whoa. Disney Springs. Those are my favorite. The live streams are my favorite.
The
interaction. The community,
it's
yes.
Really nice. Yeah.
It just blows me away that even sitting here in our living room in Oregon, there's still 13 people here, which
yeah.
is, even when I was walking around Disney, 13 people was a good turnout. 20 if it was like just something big was happening, but that was a good turnout. I'm excited. I'm happy that you guys are here and that we're building a community. That is awesome. Tony, homework. Go and watch License to Kill movie. Oh, to see the scene from Key West. Yeah.
Tony.
Furman, Lady B, I subscribe to your channel.
Hey, thank
Furman
you.
Furman Family of Interest.
So
yes,
nice. Thank
you.
You
so much.
It's just casual videos of behind the scenes, what goes on in our daily lives
yeah.
behind the Incognito Mouse channel. So, should be fun.
Oh, no, Dave said Bud Light Next.
Oh, it's called Bud Light Next.
That's the name of a drink.
Just don't drink Bud Light Next.
Oh, I thought you meant, like, drink hard liquor and then drink Bud Light Next.
Don't do that either.
Like, don't have vodka and then drink Bud Light Next.
That doesn't mix well.
No, but you mean that's actually a drink. It's not a drink. It's terrible. Throw it in the trash if it's given to you. Don't even take it.
I bet my brother would drink it.
Yeah, probably. Mm-hmm. I love that Adam takes his mom on his trip. Sometimes his dad, too. Yeah. But his dad seems like he's more busy. Death Star says, ooh, no, have you tried, Death Star, have you tried the Bud Light Next?
Ew, no.
Is it terrible?
Jimmy found, ew.
Yeah. Yeah. Dude, that's like the first, time I tried PBR, Pabst Blue Ribbon, like, I'm going to drink PBR because I always grew up.
I can now.
I always grew up with, like, people in the South and people in Georgia and the South, always, like, Larry the Cable Guy type of people would always have, like, the Pabst Blue Ribbon beer shirt on or hat on, whatever. I thought, well, that's
cheapest
cool.
Beer.
That must be like a nice redneck beer. I didn't like it. Did not like it. It's a zero. Oh, it's a zero carb
beer.
Well,
that's why it's gross.
Bud Light Next. It's like zero carb.
Anything zero carb is pretty much nasty.
That's right. Me and my friend did, and we wanted to throw up immediately. You tried the Bud Light Next.
Nice. Yeah.
Why not be trying that then? Tony, I'm going to be laughing for a while. Forrest Lazy Eye.
Forrest Lazy Eye.
He didn't stay around for long. He must
no,
have just
he didn't.
Popped in to make a goofy comment and then left. Or maybe he's still here and it's not commenting. Yeah. Forrest Whitaker's left Lazy Eye. Are you still here? If you're still here, just give us a little yo or whatever like that. Dave Gibson, I agree. Put it in the trash. Lo pone la basura. That's when I said next.
Next.
Oh, yeah.
Next.
Nope. No thanks. Not drinking that garbage anymore.
Yeah.
That garbage.
Garbage.
Dave, I dumped the whole 12-pack because a YouTuber told me it sucked, so I had to try it. You tried it because I said it was bad? She's like, oh, I have to try this.
And you got a 12-pack of it? Wow, Dave.
She just went to, like, the convenience store and got one, like, right? Like a... whatever, the tall one, or tall boy, whatever.
Yeah.
But, you know.
22.
Pew, pew, pew.
Pew, pew, pew.
Well, at least now we know. You took one for the team, Dave. Now I know to never try it.
Dave, never have again. You ever tried Beverly?
Oh, that drink.
Adam Nawu did a video on when he tried Beverly, and he hated it.
He said he almost threw up?
Yeah.
I've never tried Beverly. I actually want to try it, just because everyone says it's so bad. Guess that's kind of what you did, right, Dave? Like someone said that Bud Light Next was so bad, so you tried it.
Don't do it.
I take it you've had a bad experience with Beverly, Brian?
Apparently.
Dave, I'm in Maine. They don't sell small amounts here.
everything's Costco size.
Yeah. Dave has never tried Beverly before. Reserve budgeting. Total Wine allows you to buy individual drinks. Oh, okay. Furman Family Adventure. Beverly is so disgusting.
That's what I've heard.
It's one of those things where you just want to try it because you know it's so bad. Like, I'm brave. I'm going to try it.
I don't want to try
it. Death Star. Mom got me to try it. And she started laughing at me after. I can't imagine your mom doing that. Your mom? Wow.
I mean, I guess. Drink two cups of Beverly. Tony, are you kidding?
Is this a challenge? All right. Hold my Beverly.
Hold my Beverly.
We're going to try this. Death Star. Krista. That's Death Star's mom is Krista.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. You want to see how bad it... Yeah, exactly. I want to see how bad it actually is.
Well, can you just do like a little tester cup?
Yeah,
just a little taste?
I think that's what they have at that place, right? Taste. They only have like little mouthwash cups, like little 2-ounce cups.
Like mouthwash.
Yeah. You don't actually get a big cup. They have all the different flavors. They used to have it, but then they shut it down, but now they opened it back up again at Epcot. No, I can stand up the two small cups. You can, oh, they're little tiny cups, yeah. So you can hack at least two of them. Not two big, huge cups, like not two 12-ounce cups. So it's like two little 2-ounce cups. Andy, we watch all the Disney vloggers, and it is the best when you can actually talk and interact.
Yes.
We prefer straight vodka.
Ooh.
If I
mean, flavored, I could do maybe a small shot of flavored vodka.
Yeah. If I drink straight liquor, it has to be Fireball. That's the only thing I like to. I love shots of Fireball. I love it. Although I've heard that Jack Daniels has a Tennessee Fire, number 7 Tennessee Fire.
Sinfire
is a different one. That's a different one. But Jack Daniels just has a number 7, which is their signature blend. But they have a Tennessee Fire that's cinnamon flavor. And I've heard it's a very, very good. But,
thanks, Dave.
But I love to just sip or even just take shots of Fireball. I love it. It's my favorite.
Dave is on it.
I think they're called Sifters. That's a sifter of wine, right? That was a Simpsons episode where they did Sherry Bobbins. Remember that? Ever seen the one where they made fun of Mary Poppins? My favorite.
Yes, Sherry Bobbins.
My
yeah.
favorite Simpsons episode ever. And Barney's out there singing, "Buy me a beer, $2 a glass." And he says, "Someone help me, I'm freezing my butt." He says, "Buy me some brandy, a sifter of wine." So I always thought sifter had something to do with wine. I don't know what a sifter is. But when you said that, it reminded me of that episode, my favorite all-time episode. But going back to Andy, you watch all the Disney vloggers, and it's best when you can actually talk and interact. Yes, that's my favorite part, too. Mm-hmm. Not even just making videos so much, but doing this. This is my favorite. I'd love to just set my tripod up at Epcot or at Disney Springs and just sit and talk. Just walk around and talk. That's my favorite. I love when people ask me, what's my favorite experience? What's my best time at Disney? What's so cool about being a cast member? That's the stuff that I love. And I can't wait to get back and be a cast member again. I love it so much. Furman, I hope you guys move down and your wife gets a job working at Disney on Disney World property. That would be so great.
Yeah.
At Club Cool, they're a little bit bigger than a Dixie cup. They're 4-ounce cups. Okay. Uh-oh. Reptilian. Uh-oh.
Yeah. Dave was on it.
Oh, you see it?
I was about to do it, but I was like too slow. Dave was like, boom. Gone.
Day 3, 2, 1.
Yeah, I saw it.
On it. I didn't even see it. I'm so busy talking. I'm not making. I don't see the comments until later. Thank you, Dave, for being on
I'll
that.
Tell you later.
Thank you, mods. You mods are on it. Mm-hmm. I respect and I love you guys. I never have a problem with you kicking people out. I remember one time somebody was complaining about mods having authority. I'm like, yo, I give my mods the authority and I let them run the show.
Yeah, it was Wingnut when he got mad because I kicked him out. Wingnut. He kept repeatedly calling you a goober over and over again. It was
and
just too much.
Came back on another video later and just left the comment, can you call off your dogs or whatever? I'm just trying to have fun or whatever. I'm like, oh, I don't. I'm so busy responding to the comments that I read. I'm not looking at the comments as they're coming down. That's the mods. That's what they do. And I appreciate that because I didn't see the other person that you banned earlier. I didn't see any of the Kemplar or whatever. I didn't see what that person said.
Yeah.
But you guys are on it.
On it.
Resort budgeting. Drinking Beverly may straighten up Forrest's lazy eye.
Or may get the other one wonky. So they might have two lazy eyes. One or the other.
Death Star 5000. Crown Royal Apple is good too. You know what I like to do? I like to take Angry Orchard and put a shot of Fireball in it. Then it's like cinnamon apple. That is good.
Yeah.
I bet you Crown Royal Apple would be good too. That sounds good. Visit Dollywood on the way down.
That would be fun.
I've never been to Dollywood. That would be fun.
I like that a lot.
We may have to reconfigure.
I really like Dolly Parton.
We may have to revisit our, because we kind of have our route roughly mapped out where we're going to go, where we have some friends in Wyoming that we're going to stop and visit, and we're going to stop in Nashville, and we kind of have a rough idea where we're going to stop, but maybe we'll check that out just for poops and ha-has, just to see.
Yeah, just we'll have to figure out exactly where it's at and how close it is to our route.
Yeah. Yes, Crown Apple is good. Dolly World is way cheaper than other parks.
Oh, I bet.
I'm sure it is. Probably just like the one in Branson. What's the one in Branson? Silver Dollar City. That's another one that I'd like to go to. Sir Willow goes there a lot. Sir Willow used to work there, and he worked at Busch Gardens in Tampa, and he worked, of course, at Disney World. He was a Photo Pass cast member. But I'd love to go to Dollar World. I'd love to go to Silver Dollar City and some of those off places. Maybe someday that'll become part of our channel. Maybe we'll go around. Once you guys get the word out and get us enough subscriptions to become a big-time YouTuber, and I won't have to work at Disney, or you won't have to be a nurse, whatever, we can
you
just...
You love to work. You love working at Disney.
I do.
I think you would do it anyway.
I do. I think I would just go down to part-time if that ever became a thing, if our channel became big enough that we actually made money off of it. I would just become a part-time Disney driver and go travel around and do videos
that'd
and go explore stuff and then work at Disney, whatever, 3-4 days a week, and then go out and get an RV and just go travel around.
That'd be fun.
Adam DeWoo style. Dollywood is way cheaper. I'm about 5 hours from Dollywood. Oh,
Oh,
in
it's
North
not far.
Carolina. Nice.
Nice.
They had a train accident in Silver Dollar City recently. Oh, wow.
Dang.
That's what Strillo did. He was one of the train robbers or something like that, right? Death Star. I recently tried Stone Cold's brand of beer. The lager is good. I didn't like the IPA. I don't like IPA. I don't like it. It's a big thing here in Oregon. I don't like it. It's bitter. They call it hoppy, but to me, it's just bitter and it just tastes like nastiness. I don't like it. Tennessee Old Smoky has that cinnamon apple and it's delicious. Uh-oh. We're being attacked here. We're getting a lot of trolls tonight.
Tonight we are.
That's
We
a
didn't get
good thing
any
though.
last
It's a
time.
good thing when you get trolls, 'cause that
That's
means
it.
people are watching. That means you're out there and people are picking up and seeing it. If you don't get trolls, then you're not doing something right. If you get trolls, you're doing something right because that means that people are seeing you and they're coming in. And any kind of publicity is good publicity. So that's good. I'm glad that I have a bunch of moderators that are on it.
3, 2, 1.
Timed out for 300 seconds. So you got 5 minute timeout, GF. Get your act together. You can come back. If not, you'll be kicked out for good. I agree. Bitter is hoppy. Yeah, I
Hoppy.
don't like it. Uh-oh, you were hidden. All right, so Tony went ahead and Dave put you
Nice.
down and Tony knocked you out. All right, well, again, I didn't see what GF said, but
That's stupid.
yeah, it always is.
I swear it's like 12-year-old kids in there.
It always is. Yeah.
Yeah.
It quick. That was quick. Yeah. So March, coming down to Disney for a couple days. May, not very appropriate, Tony said. Yeah, I'm sure. I didn't even see it. May will be down in Disneyland
In
for a
May,
week.
yeah. Honeymoon.
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 Andy, we promise we aren't trolls. Oh yeah, I know
Not
that,
you,
yeah.
Andy.
We love you, and that is one of our home time parks. Yeah, no, not you. A couple of people were. We promise you, yes, that is one of our home. Yeah. I'm glad you're here, Andy.
Very
I'm
glad.
glad you're part of the live stream tonight. Welcome to come back anytime. I love it.
Yeah.
But again, March Disney World, May Disneyland, and then July, Florida for good.
For good.
Boom. Follow our journey. Follow Lady B's channel as she navigates through the nursing world and what she's gonna do. Is she gonna transfer from her current job? Is she gonna find a different job? I mean, there are so many nursing jobs in there. You can have whatever you
Oh
want.
yeah, I've already looked. There's at least 100 that I could see.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good pay,
Yep.
good benefits,
Yep.
good sign-on bonuses, all that kind of stuff. You're just gonna be able to pick whatever you want. That's gonna be great. And I already know what I want. I'm going there to do what I want. I
Do
already
it.
have my job picked out, lined up. I'm excited.
Yeah.
I'm ready. Furman, oh, this is for you. Question for Lady B. Are you able to share what kind of nursing you do?
Sure. Right now I'm doing dialysis. So it's kidney dialysis. People have had their kidneys fail. We hook them up to a machine, and the machine dialyzes their kidneys for them, basically. Their blood runs all their blood through the system. We have an artificial kidney hooked up to every machine and cleans out the blood for them. So it's pretty cool.
It filters our blood because their
Filters the
kidneys
blood.
can't do it for them
Kidneys aren't
anymore.
working, yeah. So filters all that yucky toxins out of their blood.
Yep.
That's what I'm doing right now.
Yep.
Yeah.
For a while, you work with the mom baby unit.
Yeah, I spent 7 years on mother baby and labor and delivery, and got my nursing license and moved on from that particular job. Wanted to try some different things, get some different nursing skills under my belt. So right now I'm in dialysis.
Yep. Dave says there are tons of old people that need nurses, and you've looked into that too. You've looked into, yeah. Old
Just kidding.
guy that needs a nurse, yep. You looked into home health care in Florida for
I
like the.
did. I'm interested in hospice. I might do hospice or home health.
Yeah.
But we'll see.
Dave says that is awesome, Lady B. Can you post her channel again since we were late joining? Yes.
Well, of course.
Yes. Let's see here. Control G, youtube.com/LadyB83.
83.
LadyB83. Right now, she only has two videos because she just started. But it's like more home vlogs, more behind the scenes stuff. It seems like this channel is becoming more live streams, because that's just what I love doing. But I do love making videos too. And when I have worthy content of making a video, I will. And I actually was going to talk about this daily vlog thing and my hand getting injured, and Lady Bichon, I was going to make a video, but then she just messaged me this afternoon. I'm like, we should go live tonight. I'm like, heck yes. Heck yes, we'll go live. I love going live.
It's fun.
Furman, I used to work in hospital security. That's why I asked. Yeah. We have a special needs daughter.
Yeah, I would love to do that. Just do home health, where I go in people's houses and take care of, you know, one patient in a one-on-one nursing.
Yeah.
And you do your job at that house for that day or for that time and move on to another house. And
much more personal. You develop relationships.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you have more autonomy that way too.
Nice. Tony says, we just got our parents a generator for her dialysis when the power goes out. That's That's a good idea, because that's scary.
Mm-hmm.
The power goes out, you have to go to dialyze your blood. My mom was an ER nurse. Nice.
Very nice. I have worked in the ER a little bit as a CNA. Very fast paced.
Before you got your nurse's license?
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Yeah.
ER nurse. That's hardcore right there.
It is. It's a lot. It's stressful.
Tony says she does hers at home every night.
Yeah, she's on home hemo.
And your place you work at has a home side too, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, my mom is the little clinic manager of the home department. So some people can do dialysis at home.
Yeah.
Others have to go in-center if they're not really cooperative with their dialysis care. So they have to come in-center, and that's what I'm doing right now, is in-center dialysis nursing. But if you can do home hemo, that's the best way to go.
The better?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. But you can hook, some people can do it while they're sleeping.
Yeah. Really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Deathstar 5000 says, this is so random, but I remember when you did parody Christian music videos. That's how this YouTube channel started. Like, I had this YouTube channel for like 12 years, and that's what I used to do. I used to be a pastor. I used to be Death Star. I used to be a pastor in your church. I was a youth pastor. I worked with young people. And so I started taking popular songs on the radio, and I would make Christian versions of them. And it was fun, but it was super cringy. Looking back on that, it's like super awkward. And the, yeah, I won't get into too much, but there was a moment where I said, this looks really weird. And there was a moment where the Catholic Church was having a lot of issues with like their priests, you know, and young boys. And, you know, I was like, this looks really weird. This looks really, really weird. And so I just kind of stopped.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. There was one video where I did where it was T-Pain, I'm gonna buy you a drink. And I did a version called I'm gonna bring you to church, because a lot of the kids in my youth group couldn't get to church. So we had a church van and I'd go pick them up. Or even when I was at the church in California, yeah, it was a big white van with no windows. Yeah. And I had candy. No, we had a white church van. Yeah. When I was at Death Star's church, we had a church van. I'd go pick people up. But I would pick people up in my car, and I would do this T-Pain. I'm going to bring you to church. And going back, listening to it, I was like, that sounds really creepy. Like, you don't even, you know, I'll just come get you and bring you to church. I was like, I'm done. This is just weird. This is really weird. So I stopped.
That's funny.
Yeah, that was, yeah. But that's where this channel started. And that's where I had a video that went kind of semi-viral. There was a Cholo rap song called I Lean Like a Cholo, which a Cholo is just like a Mexican slang for like a Southern California wannabe gangster or whatever. And so there was a song called Lean Like a Cholo, and I made one called I Act Like a Christian, and it got like hundreds and hundreds of thousands of views overnight, which back then that was viral. Now it's millions, but back then, 12 years ago, when you were still in diapers, that was viral. So that's where I got thousands of subscribers. And then thousands of them left, and then I got more, and my channel went dormant for a while because I had some trolls that were like really, really bad trolls, like really bad, like we're calling my job and trying to get me fired, and you know, like really interacting in my life. So I shut down the channel for like years. I closed it and stopped doing anything. Yeah, they got me fired. They contacted my church and said things about me that weren't true, like trolls. Like you've heard stories of big YouTubers like doxing their house and like. Like, I had people find out where the church I worked at and called them and told them things about me that weren't true. And I got, you know, I got called into the office, and I had to just stop the channel. It was bad. But that's a long string of unfortunate church events that led me to work at Disney instead. But that's another story for another day. That star, you know about that. You know a little bit about that. Tony, they can still do dialysis without the machine. It takes a lot of
work.
Yeah,
it's a little hand crank. The crank, the pump.
Wow.
A lot of work.
Dave, I was a youth pastor. Yeah, I worked with teenagers and children. I was like the children's side. Yeah, people are terrible. People.
Yeah, sad.
People see a little bit of success and they want to tear people down and they want to make them feel bad so they feel better about themselves, I think. It's just part of human nature. If you feel bad about yourself, you can either rise yourself up or you can pull people down. It's easier to
pull people down.
To be a hater and to be a troll. Like we've seen three trolls in here already tonight. Probably a 12-year-old kid drinking Mountain Dew Red in their mama's basement playing Call of Duty. Johnny Q.
Hey, Johnny Q.
Hello, Johnny Q. Welcome to our live stream. It's already been an hour and 45 minutes just sitting, chatting. Death Star says, you were a great pastor. I had a lot of fun. First person I ever baptized was Death Star 500's older brother. Baptized him.
That's cool.
First time. Yep. So that was good. Andy, we support you both in your adventures and wish you the best of luck. Good night. Thank you, Andy. Have a good night.
Come back.
Yeah, we'll be back again. We'll do live streams again soon. Yeah, we support you both. I got you. Have a good night. Hope to see you sometime in the future. If you ever make it down to Florida, look us up. And loving the journey. Yeah. Loving it. Yeah. Thank you for stopping in. Good night.
Good night, Andy.
Good night. It'll probably be a good night for us soon, too, because we've been on here for almost 2 hours already. Uh-oh. Johnny Q, I have a dilemma. Uh-oh.
Yep. Goodbye, Johnny Q. Suck, Johnny Q.
I think he was... Looks like he may have been asking, like, a religious question.
Oh, and I blocked him.
That's what it seemed like, a question about circumcision.
Yeah, but don't ask that here.
Yeah.
Go ask your pastor at your church.
What is a favorite thing besides Disney and Universal in Orlando you can't wait to do again? Your favorite thing besides Disney and Universal? Icon Park. Yeah. I really loved Icon Park. That was a lot of fun. I want to go do the water parks, which Legoland has a water park. SeaWorld. I went to SeaWorld one time. SeaWorld has a really awesome water park. Wawa, of course. We talked about Wawa earlier.
Excited for the warm beaches.
The beaches. Yeah. There's a lot of fun things.
Saw that coming. Yeah, I kind of did too, Dave. Anytime it's just some random pop in, it's like, ooh.
Yeah, you can. When I first saw Johnny Q, I'm like,
That's why I got my phone right here. It's ready.
You had it on the ready.
Oh, well, here we go.
Mo Lester.
Gotcha. Cute. Clever. Bye bye.
Nice.
Bye,
sucker. It reminds me of like Simpsons, Bart calling the Moe's Tavern. I'm looking for Mr. Lester. First name Mo. All right, hold on a second. I'm looking for a Mo Lester.
So terrible.
Why, you little one, I get my hands on you.
Okay, I have a story and it's embarrassing, but I'm going to tell it. So I worked at JCPenney back in like 2002, something like that. I was young and I had someone come up to me and ask to help find their brother or something like that.
Oh no.
Okay, I have blonde hair. Keep this in mind. You know, it's just going, right? So this person asked me to find their brother. I said, okay, sure. I can, you know, page him over the phone.
I'm laughing so hard I can't type.
And so they asked, I said, okay, what's your brother's name? They said, Pete. I said, okay, Pete Zahut. Yes, I did it, you guys. I paged Pete Zahut over the thing. And then I was like, that was embarrassing. I realized it as it was coming out of my mouth, that it was actually Pizza Hut. It was horrible. Chuck.
Nice to see you, Chuck. Danny 702 took us up some springs to see manatees. You guys can do that. Yes. Danny 702 actually left. She moved back to Las Vegas. Like she was in Orlando for a while, but she came out with a video and said, I can't afford this anymore. I need to go.
Tony's laughing at me.
Wish you could show these trolls how to do buckshot. How to duck buckshot. Yeah, really, right?
I wish.
I would like to go to the Manatee Springs, though, for sure. Yeah. I've seen a few manatee at Epcot, but out in the wild in the summertime when it gets warm, they come in. That would be a lot of fun. Sorry, I'm laughing on the floor.
I know, so dumb. That was probably like 20 years.
Pizza Hut.
20? I was young. I didn't hear all those things.
At least it wasn't something dirty. At least it was something, yeah. Something like that. Like,
yeah. Yeah. I allow myself at least one blah moment a day. Anything over that, I'm just dumb.
Yeah. Jonathan BD. Jonathan Big Dog. Uh-oh.
Oh, gosh. Oh, wait. Oh.
It's cool you have an actual manatee on the stream with you. An actual manatee on the stream with you.
I don't
you.
Get it.
He's talking about you. Time to go.
Oh.
Goodbye.
Wow. Well, bye-bye. Go somewhere else.
So I wonder where the algorithm sent us that we're getting all of these.
Yeah, that's true.
Like, we've never had any of those.
This
before.
Is a lot, yeah.
I hope they hit the like. I hope they do. I hope they hit the like button before they leave. Yeah. Weird. But I guess it's good because, I mean, somehow we're getting out there.
Yeah.
But you guys got to be on the ready. If you see a new name, so this person probably is the same person that has like 18 accounts. I run an adult store, could be me. What? Could be.
I guess so.
I guess so. Wow. 17 trolls tonight. Well, not really 17, but probably is quite a few coming in. I like that sometimes there's been at least two that it popped up on my screen first and said, allow or do not allow.
Yeah, show or is that hide. YouTube's filtering them or
I
something?
I guess they're picking up some kind of keyword and they're not allowing it, yeah. Oh, no.
What?
I wanted to see what his comment said.
Oh, sorry.
It said, your stream was posted on the front page of some website. So some troll website, our stream is posted on the front page of it.
Mm.
So all the trolls are coming over from there.
Oh, got it.
I wonder if it's that page that ChatterBait. I think it's the key word. That is what is keeping us from posting more on our channel.
Oh.
These dang gone trolls. I wonder if that has to do with when I did the Adam the Woo video, and my name got bounced around. What was that? Maybe stop the stream and restart. That's what I did. You don't want to know. I wonder if that, remember when I did that movie video and my name was getting bounced around that one channel? Mm-hmm. What was it called? Something dot...
Wasn't it Tattle Life?
Yeah, Tattle dot Life. My channel was getting bounced around this hate page and I was getting a lot of hate trolls from there. ChatterBait. I mean, I can only guess what that... Yeah. Could be Icky Bones taken with a sick mind? I guess, maybe. I don't know. Well, if it keeps up, we may just have to end the live stream.
Yeah.
And if we do, we won't restart it because we've already been for almost 2 hours
it's
anyway.
Been 2 hours.
Yeah, maybe we'll just go for a few more minutes, and then if another one comes in, we'll just kick that person and end it. Interesting that our live stream got posted on the front page of some weirdo.
I mean, who does that? Who's like, oh, this live stream looks like a fun one to post on this troll page.
There's another one.
Yeah. Good job, Dave. He's quick.
Dave's on it. Well, that's unfortunate.
Yeah.
It happens. But that is why a lot of people don't do live streams, because of that. Yeah. But I think, I'm pretty sure you can go in and just set keywords. It will automatically be blocked. And you can just pretty much put in every possible bad word that there is, or every possible dirty word. And if those words come up, will automatically be blocked. Probably may have to consider that in the future if this continues to happen. I don't know. We'll see. This might just be a one-off. This hasn't happened before the last couple live streams.
Yeah, the couple live streams we didn't get any trolls, I don't think.
We've done at least two or three, and it didn't happen. Mm-hmm. So.
Well, it is Saturday night. People are bored, I guess.
Yeah, they are.
The trolls are out and prowling.
The freaks come out at night. Remember that song? Hey, 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 the freaks come out at night. So maybe the freaks are all just out tonight.
Yeah.
I don't know, but that's too bad. Oh, thanks, guys. That was fun. I'll check you guys later. I'll keep sniping them.
Get
yes.
Dave. Get
thanks,
him.
Tony. Thanks for stopping in. It's been a good bit. It's been a good long,
bye, Tony.
Nice stream. Chuck. So have you been recognized by any of the other lesser Resort TV One, Disney Flu Blog, Disney Vloggers, Back in Your Driving Days? Adam gets yelled at a lot for walking around Celebration. Oh no, there's another one, huh? All right, we'll probably end in just a second. Chuck, I've never been recognized. Well, actually, kind of, I guess, sort of. After the lockdowns, after the lockdowns, the day that Disney Springs first opened up, all the big YouTubers were there. All the big YouTubers were there, and I was there. I did like a 4-hour live stream. I got so many views and so much view time there. And I saw a bunch of the big time YouTubers, and I said hi to them, whatever. And I remember I was right over by the Amphicar, when the Amphicar goes in, and I saw Nate, Mr. Morrow, and I walked up to him. I was like, "Hey, Nate, how you doing? It's Incognito Mouse." He's like, "Oh yeah, I know you," because I would comment on his videos a lot. I was very interactive on his channel, and I left a lot of comments like, "Yeah, I know you. I recognize you. Hey, buddy, how's it going?" So, I guess you could kind of count that he knew who I was, even though I approached him. He didn't approach me. Like nobody like that has ever said, "Hey, it's Incognito Mouse." Maybe one or two people have ever even said that to me at all. That not even famous people, just anybody, except for people who watch my videos, like you and like Dave and like DVC Kev, who watch my videos and say, "Hey, I'm gonna be at Disney such and such week. Can we meet up?" Then I would. But just being there, having somebody say, "Hey, it's Incognito Mouse," yeah, didn't someone throw shade at you? Yeah, that was a different story. That was Kyle Palo. He's a DB. He's a dirtbag. And a different D word, but yeah. Hey, you two, caught you then. DVC
Kev,
Kev.
what's up, Kev?
Hey.
You're missing all the trolls,
Oh,
man. So many trolls tonight.
so many trolls tonight. It's crazy. I guess someone said we were posted on some nasty website somewhere on the front page, and so all these trolls are coming up. It's been crazy. It's been a poop show. But anyway, what was that? I know
Poo
you can't set it to where someone has to
You
subscribe
can
for a certain
set
amount.
it.
Oh,
You
you
can
can
set
set
it
it
to
to where
us.
someone has to subscribe for a certain amount of time before they can post. Wow.
Oh.
Good night, friend and family adventures. I did not know that. Ring me down before you get there. We can catch you in 2024. Yes. Maybe I have to
For
look that up.
sure.
Like someone has to be subscribed to my channel for at least a month
Oh, before they can
before
comment
they
on
can
the lives.
comment.
That's kind of a good idea. I like that.
Dang it, we sucked. I was sucked into
Oh,
Yellowstone season
I
five.
thought about starting that. Did we watch the first episode?
We watched Westworld or something
Oh,
like
sounded
that.
different.
Yeah.
I kind of want to start watching that. There's so much hype about it.
Yellowstone?
Yeah.
I have heard quite a bit about that too. So, Firm Adventures, if you're still here, thank you. Dave, I'm sorry, Dave, not Dave. Yes, Dave, thank you. But Kev, welcome, Kev. Thanks for stopping in.
Help
Thanks
us keep
for.
an eye on the trolls, Kev.
Yes, we're gonna. Actually, we're probably gonna end soon because we've already been
Yeah.
here 2 hours and we have. I have to
Well,
go to work in the morning. You're off
I
tomorrow.
am, but we haven't eaten dinner yet
We
either,
haven't eaten dinner
so.
yet and it's what? 8:30 now,
Okay,
so
DVC Kev, we just said we should watch it.
watch it.
We
You
should start. Let's
won't
do
be.
one episode tonight.
We might have to do that, yeah. But if they have to be sub for a month and they can't say anything, they might not stay. Well, that's true, but that's
True.
we don't want the trolls to come in and just say something nasty and then leave. So that's kind of good. There's another one. Someone else just
Jungus.
end the stream or we will bring the heat. That's what somebody just end. All right, I'm not gonna end it now just because of that. I'm gonna be spiteful. Bring it, Big Chunga.
Big Chunga.
Big Chungus says,
We look
end
like
the
a
stream
Chungus.
or we will bring the heat. All right, well, bring it then. Bring it, son. Bring it.
Bring it on,
Bring it. Bring
sucker.
all 17
Look at all of
because.
our our moderators.
Yeah.
You think they're gonna stay in here long? Our
Bring it.
moderators are gonna zap them.
Yeah, because that's good. Because the more of you clowns that come in here, the more views that we get, and the more watch time I get, and the more exposure I get. They say any publicity
Publicity.
is good publicity. So you know what? DVC Kev, love you guys. DVC Kev is another one that I met at Magic Kingdom. He and his
Yeah,
wife.
I remember. I think you and I were doing a, where you were videoing me, and you said I have to go. I gotta go meet Kevin and his wife.
Yes, I was up at the hill, at the break room on the hill. And I came right out and I met Kev and his wife. And then it was right around dark time. Like it was almost right, Kev, it was almost dark. Like right at the witching hour, I think they call it. And Dave says, yeah. So yeah. Interesting. Now I want to go. You were on break. Yeah. Oh, I was on
Yeah,
break. Yeah,
because
Magic Kingdom.
you're talking
Yeah, I was
on
right
your
there at that
break,
little
yeah.
break room right up at the top of the hill right before you go in. I didn't go into the park and go down. I stayed out because I was going to meet up with you and the wife. Yeah.
Thank goodness.
Okay, how much? Here we go. Bring it.
Yup.
You guys take care. Look forward to the next one. Thank you. I gave you a wooden coin. That's right. Remember, those who have no fear can't type Swahili. But the trolls bring in the heat.
Yeah.
Remember, wasio na hofu is Swahili. Yep.
For they who have no fear.
Yes, I'm all caught up on Yellowstone. All right, we're going to have to watch soon then. Live stream at the range. It would be too loud. I have done a couple of videos from the range here. One at the indoor range with Lady B. And then one from, maybe one or two from Florida with my buddy Jeff and another friend, another Disney, forget his name now, it's on the tip of my tongue. But anyway, yeah, I've done a couple at the range before, and we will do more. We'll go shooting at the range
more. We need to. I mean, we're members. For sure. We haven't been since, like, maybe September.
Yeah, I kind of can't right now because of my hand, yeah, but once my hand heals up, yeah, it's kind of hard to shoot a gun when you have a gimpy hand.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Pew, pew, pew.
Yep.
Yeah. It's a 22.
Yep. Pew, pew, pew. It's a chopper. If you haven't seen that, don't.
Oh my gosh, don't.
Don't. Yeah.
But it's funny.
It is funny. Yeah. Live stream at the range. Yeah. That's what budgeting. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. Here we go.
Go away, retard.
It's cold here in the nature coast. It's cold there? Oh, yeah. Wow. It does. I will say that the humidity, with even if it's not that cold, with the Florida humidity, it does feel colder than it does like somewhere where there's not so much humidity. Like when it's 65 degrees, it really feels cold because the moisture in the air on your skin does feel colder. So there is that. This is like Aliens Ride, the one with the highest score wins. Like, they keep popping up and you shoot them down. Like, a troll comes in and whoever gets to them first, ching, you get a point. You get a bump, ching, you get a point. So, yeah, 50s with humidity. That's cold. Florida, that's cold because humidity does make it cold. It does.
Mm.
So, this is like, it's like the one at Men in Black, right? The one at Universal, the Men in Black ride. You're shooting down aliens. Or you're talking more like the one at the Zurg. The Space Ranger spin in Magic Kingdom. That one's fun too.
Mm-hmm.
Or Buzz. Yeah, Buzz Lightyear. Yeah. That's the one in the Hollywood Studios. Yeah. I think the one in Magic Kingdom is more fun.
Astro Blasters. Is that the one?
What? No, Astro Blaster is the ride that spins around on top of.
No, that's Astro Orbiter.
Astro Orbiter. One of them is called Buzz Lightyear Space Ranger Spin.
Oh, it's okay. So it's called different. At Disneyland than it is
Magic. Maybe, okay, that's what a Disneyland has got a different name. Okay, got it. Okay, maybe it is called Astro. I don't know, Disneyland, that makes sense. In Anaheim, yeah. That's what Steven says, yeah. And Men in Black is Wave. The one, MIB is fun. I did like that one. The one in Tomorrowland at Disneyland is called Astro Blaster. Okay, well, that makes sense. Got it. Okay. You're going Monday.
Nice.
Oh, strawberry jelly. Super jelly, super jelly. Buzz is in, okay. Toy Story Mania is in Hollywood Studios. Yeah, Death Star. Kind of wish they would have kept the great movie right. Oh, me too. Oh, come on, Disney stuff official. Get rid of Disney staff official. Someone did. Okay, whatever.
Disney staff official.
Oh, DVC gave current him for Disney staff official.
Ooh.
Oh, okay.
We believe it.
So maybe, yeah. Was timed out.
Wow. It's about cold as it is here, I think.
Current temp 48, yeah.
It's probably about 48 here.
But the Florida, we're not used to that kind of stuff. They're freezing.
Yeah.
And we still only have, 10, 11. So they come in, they say what they need to say, and then they leave. So they're not sticking around because they're getting kicked. Okay, well, maybe we should just end it here then.
Let's
get something to eat. We'll watch some Yellowstone. Thank you for those of you who were here that were helping kick people out.
Thank
That's
you guys.
Weird.
You guys are awesome.
I miss Maelstrom. Oh yeah, me too. The Frozen ride's all right, but Maelstrom is where it was at. Mm-hmm. I liked how it was open, and you could see the car come out a little bit.
People are so weird.
They are. Whatever. All right. Anyway, we're gonna end it then. Have a good night, guys. We'll try this again another time, and we'll see if maybe we don't have so many trolls next time. And remember. Wasio na hofu is Swahili for they who have no fear.
Hurry back. Not you trolls.
Not you trolls. Have a great night.
Bye, guys. Thanks for the stream.
Bye.